during the game from inside the ballpark only. On non-game days, the store is open Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Children 14 and under can become members of the Bethpage Federal Credit Union Long Island Ducks Kids Club today. Kids will receive a unique gift package and take part in a variety of fun activities that come with being a member of the Kids Club. For more information on how to sign your child up, please call 631-940-3825 during normal business hours. Quacker Jack, the seven-time best Long Island mascot, is now available for appearances at parties and other special events throughout the Long Island community. Please contact the Community Relations Department at 631-940-3825 to find out more information and to book an appearance. Once again, thank you for tuning in to the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network. Today's game will begin momentarily. You're tuned in to the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network. Today's Long Island Ducks game broadcast will begin shortly. Every game this season will be broadcast live on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network with high-definition video and audio via Boxcast. Fans can tune into the game on the Ducks' official Facebook page and YouTube channel, as well as the team's official website, liducks.com. Thank you for tuning in, and stand by for complete coverage of today's game. 2017 Long Island Ducks season ticket packages are on sale now. Enjoy the best savings and most benefits available to cheer on your hometown team. 10-game mini plans are also on sale and offer fans the same great seats for 10 games throughout 2017, as well as many other exciting opportunities. To find out more information and secure your seats for the 18th season of Ducks baseball, please call 631-940-3825 during normal business hours. The Bethpage Ballpark box office is now open for individual ticket sales. Box office hours are Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and Saturday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Fans can also purchase their tickets by calling 631-940-TIXX or by visiting liducks.com and clicking on the tickets icon. The Ducks offer many packages available for groups with as little as 25 people to as many as 2,000. We offer block seating, pregame and in-game picnics, luxury suites, our exclusive Smoke and Al's party deck, and so much more. In addition, groups have the opportunity to take part in a variety of experiences, such as performing the national anthem or taking the field with the Ducks as the dream team. Group ticket packages for the 2017 season are now on sale. For more information on Ducks group outings, call 631-940-3825 or visit liducks.com. Looking for official Long Island Ducks merchandise, hard-to-find memorabilia, team apparel, and so much more? Then be sure to check out the Waddle In Shop, the official merchandise store of the Ducks. Fans can visit the shop online anytime at liducks.com by clicking on the merchandise icon. Store hours on game days are noon to 4 p.m. and during the game from inside the ballpark only. On non-game days, the store is open Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Children 14 and under can become members of the Bethpage Federal Credit Union Long Island Ducks Kids Club today. Kids will receive a unique gift package and take part in a variety of fun activities that come with being a member of the Kids Club. For more information on how to sign your child up, please call 631-940-3825 during normal business hours. Quacker Jack, the seven-time best Long Island mascot, is now available for appearances at parties and other special events throughout the Long Island community. Please contact the Community Relations Department at 631-940-3825 to find out more information and to book an appearance. Once again, thank you for tuning in to the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network. Today's game will begin momentarily. You're tuned in to the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network. Today's Long Island Ducks game broadcast will begin shortly. Every game this season will be broadcast live on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network with high-definition video and audio via Boxcast. Fans can tune into the game on the Ducks' official Facebook page and YouTube channel, as well as the team's official website, liducks.com. Thank you for tuning in, and stand by for complete coverage of today's game. 2017 Long Island Ducks season ticket packages are on sale now. Enjoy the best savings and most benefits available to cheer on your hometown team. 10-game mini plans are also on sale and offer fans the same great seats for 10 games throughout 2017, as well as many other exciting opportunities. To find out more information and secure your seats for the 18th season of Ducks Baseball, please call 631-940-3825 during normal business hours. The Bethpage Ballpark box office is now open for individual ticket sales. Box office hours are Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., and Saturday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Fans can also purchase their tickets by calling 631-940-TIXX or by visiting liducks.com and clicking on the tickets icon. The Ducks offer many packages available for groups with as little as 25 people to as many as 2,000. We offer block seating, pregame and in-game picnics, luxury suites, our exclusive Smoke and Al's party deck, and so much more. In addition, groups have the opportunity to take part in a variety of experiences, such as performing the national anthem or taking the field with the Ducks as the dream team. Group ticket packages for the 2017 season are now on sale. For more information on Ducks group outings, call 631-940-3825 or visit liducks.com. Looking for official Long Island Ducks merchandise, hard-to-find memorabilia, team apparel, and so much more? Then be sure to check out the Waddle In Shop, the official merchandise store of the Ducks. Fans can visit the shop online anytime at liducks.com by clicking on the merchandise icon. Store hours on game days are noon to 4 p.m. and during the game from inside the ballpark only. On non-game days, the store is open Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Children 14 and under can become members of the Bethpage Federal Credit Union Long Island Ducks Kids Club today. Kids will receive a unique gift package and take part in a variety of fun activities that come with being a member of the Kids Club. For more information on how to sign your child up, please call 631-940-3825 during normal business hours. Quacker Jack, the seven-time best Long Island mascot, is now available for appearances at parties and other special events throughout the Long Island community. Please contact the Community Relations Department at 631-940-3825 to find out more information and to book an appearance. Once again, thank you for tuning in to the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network. Today's game will begin momentarily. You're tuned in to the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network. Today's Long Island Ducks game broadcast will begin shortly. Every game this season will be broadcast live on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network with high-definition video and audio via Boxcast. Fans can tune into the game on the Ducks' official Facebook page and YouTube channel, as well as the team's official website, liducks.com. Thank you for tuning in, and stand by for complete coverage of today's game. 2017 Long Island Ducks season ticket packages are on sale now. Enjoy the best savings and most benefits available to cheer on your hometown team. 10-game mini plans are also on sale and offer fans the same great seats for 10 games throughout 2017, as well as many other exciting opportunities. To find out more information and secure your seats for the 18th season of Ducks Baseball, please call 631-940-3825 during normal business hours. The Bethpage Ballpark box office is now open for individual ticket sales. Box office hours are Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and Saturday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Fans can also purchase their tickets by calling 631-940-TIXX or by visiting liducks.com and clicking on the tickets icon. The Ducks offer many packages available for groups with as little as 25 people to as many as 2,000. We offer block seating, pregame and in-game picnics, luxury suites, our exclusive Smoke and Al's party deck, and so much more. In addition, groups have the opportunity to take part in a variety of experiences, such as performing the national anthem or taking the field with the Ducks as the dream team. Group ticket packages for the 2017 season are now on sale. For more information on Ducks group outings, call 631-940-3825 or visit liducks.com. Looking for official Long Island Ducks merchandise, hard-to-find memorabilia, team apparel, and so much more? Then be sure to check out the Waddle In Shop, the official merchandise store of the Ducks. Fans can visit the shop online anytime at liducks.com by clicking on the merchandise icon. Store hours on game days are noon to 4 p.m. and during the game from inside the ballpark only. On non-game days, the store is open Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Children 14 and under can become members of the Bethpage Federal Credit Union Long Island Ducks Kids Club today. Kids will receive a unique gift package and take part in a variety of fun activities that come with being a member of the Kids Club. For more information on how to sign your child up, please call 631-940-3825 during normal business hours. Quacker Jack, the seven-time best Long Island mascot, is now available for appearances at parties and other special events throughout the Long Island community. Please contact the Community Relations Department at 631-940-3825 to find out more information and to book an appearance. Once again, thank you for tuning in to the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network. Today's game will begin momentarily.
This is Long Island Ducks Baseball.
Justin Davies at the plate, the winning run at third. Crowd going nuts. Swung on, bouncing ball, left side, off the mitt, up third baseman Brad Brown. Here comes Willie Rodriguez. Justin Davies has done it again. The Ducks are one quack away from the championship.
Jason Johnson makes the catch. He makes the catch, and the Long Island Ducks have swept the Camden River Sharks. They are the 2004 Atlantic League champions.
Going back is Adam Bailey. He settles under it. He makes the catch. Adam Bailey makes the catch. And for a second straight year, the Atlantic League trophy will reside on Long Island. The Ducks are the Atlantic League champions.
Swinging a ground ball, hit toward short, charging in his lines. He fields, throws to first. The comeback is complete. From 2-0 down in the series, the Long Island Ducks have won 3 in a row at home. And for the 5th time in franchise history, we'll head to the Atlantic League Championship Series.
And now it's time for the Long Island Ducks pregame show.
We are live here at Bethpage Ballpark in Central Islip, New York, and it is time once again for Long Island Ducks baseball. Tonight is the start of a very big four-game series, a Liberty Division matchup, and a Ferry Cup Series battle as the Long Island Ducks take on the cross-town rival Bridgeport Bluefish in the first of four games from Bethpage Ballpark. Well, good evening, everybody. My name is Michael Pollack. I'll be bringing you the play-by-play for all of tonight's action. Thank you so much for tuning in once again here on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network, whether you're joining us via Facebook Live, liducks.com, or youtube.com/ducksbaseball. Appreciate you joining us once again for the start of what will be a very important series in determining the second-half champion in the Liberty Division. Right now, the Ducks 11-14 in the second half. They have dropped two straight games, and they come into this four-game series 2.5 games behind their opponent, the Bridgeport Bluefish, who are 14-12 in the second half and holding on to first place by a thread in the Liberty Division. Somerset currently sits just a half game behind them at 13-12. And they have the day off today, so a chance for Bridgeport to go one game clear of Somerset and 3.5 games clear of Long Island, but also a chance for the Ducks to close to within a game and a half in the divisional standings against their cross-town rivals. Ducks lead the Ferry Cup Series 7-6. They took 2 of 3 here back in the middle of June from Bridgeport, but they will be looking to come up with a series victory here, and that is going to be super important for the Ducks. A series loss would be devastating to their postseason hopes. Still a long way to go in the second half, but the Ducks certainly need to start winning series on a consistent basis, especially after dropping their second series of the 6-game road trip yesterday, falling to the York Revolution 4-3 in the final game of the 3-game set, rubber game of the series. Things did start off well for the Ducks, though, as in the first inning, Quinton Berry singled, moved to second on a bunt, moved to third on a ground ball, and that brought to the plate Mark Krause. 3-1. Krause swings a line drive up the middle into center field, base hit. Berry's going to trot in from third base with the game's opening run. It's a 2-out RBI single for Mark Krause, who extends his on-base streak to 18 consecutive games, and the Ducks lead it 1-0. And Long Island would extend the lead to 2-0 two innings later against Steve Janis, the starter for the Revolution, with two outs, back-to-back singles for him, to lead off the inning from Dan Lyons. And Quinton Berry put runners at the corners, and then with one out up came Jordan Pacheco in his last 18 games. So he has been red hot, and that's why he's been in the number three spot of the order. Here he hits a ground ball weakly to short, should be enough to get the run home. Dent Fields, the off-balance throw to first, is in time for the out. Scoring, though, from third on the play is Dan Lyons. It's an RBI ground out for Jordan Pacheco, and the Ducks lead it 2-0. So Pacheco drives in a run with a ground ball, and the Ducks had a 2-0 lead after three innings in support of Alfredo Simon, who struck out 7 of the first 10 batters that he faced, allowing just a single. In the fourth, though, he ran into some trouble, and that came after the Ducks loaded the bases with two outs but missed an opportunity to score when Quinton Berry grounded out to first. In the bottom of the inning, Simon hit the leadoff hitter, Alexi Casilla, then allowed a single to Isaias Tejeda that put runners at first and third. They got the lead runner at home plate on a fielder's choice ground out for Michael Burgess, but Telvin Nash then delivered an RBI single, and that made it a 2-1 game. But a double play got Simon out of trouble. And in the fifth inning, the Ducks loaded the bases on three walks from Janis. And with one out, he came out of the game. In came lefty Jared Gaynor, and up came Ruben Gotay. 2-1. Ripped in the air to center field. That ball's going to get down for a base hit. Cleary Jr. will score. Pacheco around third. The throw to the plate from Alonzo Harris. It's in time. Pacheco is out at home plate as he got tagged on the thigh coming in. I think Kevin Baez was trying to say that Pacheco had a run outside of the baseline to try and get to the plate, but he is thrown out at the plate. And so it's just an RBI single for Ruben Gotay, and the Ducks lead 3-1. So Gotay with the RBI single to make it 3-1, though it could have been more. And for the second straight inning, the Ducks would load the bases with two out, but ultimately left them loaded when Alfonso pumped to left. And that would loom large because in the bottom of the inning, with one out and the bases empty, back-to-back singles from Carlos Trienfeld and Ryan Dent. And then Alonzo Harris, a three-run home run over the left field wall, his team leading 14th of the year, that hit off of Simon. And the Revolution had a 4-3 lead that would hold up throughout. The Ducks got a runner to third with one out in the sixth inning, but Cleary Jr. and Pacheco struck out swinging, and that was the last chance the Ducks would have as they fell 4-3. Take a break here on the pregame show. When we come back, I'll sit down with Ducks outfielder Quinton Berry, who last night returned from a quad strain and got three hits for Long Island, all singles, scored a run, and stole two bases.
Hey, fans. This is manager Kevin Baez, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Going way back is Joe Holden, and he is looking up, and that one is headed to field 5 at Robert Moses. The waves are gnarly, and the Ducks have tied it at 1.
That was another home run for the Ducks. And Duck fans, what's more fun than a home run that helps the Ducks win a game? How about a homer that helps the community win? Chappie's Funeral Home and the Long Island Ducks have once again teamed up for the Chappie's Home Run Challenge. If the Ducks hit 100 homers this season, Chappie's Funeral Home will donate $5,000 to the Quacker Jack Foundation. So every time a Ducks hitter goes deep this season, watch for the Chappie's Challenge Home Run count on the scoreboard. And if we reach 100, we're all a winner. Chappie's Funeral Home, where caring for others is a family tradition.
Can't get enough of the Long Island Ducks? Well, now you can get even more inside info on your favorite hometown team through Facebook and Twitter. The Ducks are constantly updating fans through social media with scores, transactions, ballpark promotions, and much more. You can even win great prizes. All you'll need to do is make a free account on Facebook and Twitter, and then visit us at Facebook.com/LIDucks and Twitter.com/LIDucks. Think you're Long Island's biggest Ducks fan? Get connected now.
Back here at Bethpage Ballpark, getting ready for tonight's game between the Long Island Ducks and the Bridgeport Bluefish to start off a four-game series. Quinton Berry returned to the lineup after missing four games with a quad strain and got off to a good start in his return. 3-for-5 with a run scored and 2 stolen bases. I caught up with the former big leaguer before tonight's game. Quinton, first game back after missing 4 with a quad injury. You have 3 hits, 2 stolen bases. It seemed like you didn't miss a beat there after coming back into the lineup yesterday.
Yeah, Dottie did a good job. Making sure that I took care of my body and didn't, suffer any long-term injury, and kind of got after it. I was able to get back feeling pretty close to 100%.
How did that injury kind of come about, and what was it
what was the rehab like for you to just to kind of go through that and make sure that things didn't get worse?
Like I said, she caught it early. She didn't want me pushing it, so I was able to not seriously hurt myself. And so that made it easier for her to kind of, you know, control it as well as get it back quicker than most times you hurt your quad.
In addition to having those two stolen bases, as we mentioned, three hits, seemed like you were seeing the ball particularly well last night against Steve Janis in the Revolution bullpen. Did you feel very comfortable when you were up there at the plate? And overall, how good are you feeling right now when you step in there?
I feel pretty good. I was seeing the ball pretty well. I was getting pretty good pitches a hit. But, you know, over my last four or five games, I'm starting to kind of feel a little rhythm and kind of understand my swing. I had a lot of time off before I got here, so it's kind of been a little rocky start. But I'm starting to kind of understand where I want to be, where my swing's at, and things are starting to get rolling.
You talk about that time off. Speak about, as a hitter, how difficult it is to not see live pitching for as long as you did and then jump in there playing games in the Atlantic League and having to produce right away, how difficult that is.
It's difficult, but it's as hard as you make it. You know, one of two things can happen. You either start off really, really hot and it becomes easy, or you start off slow and you start panicking, and then you want to try to prove that you can play and that you're not struggling. So then, you know, you start kind of to a spiral downward. But I'm starting to feel good, so getting some confidence back and put some good swings together, so that's all I can do.
It didn't ever seem like you'd push that panic button when you were getting off to a little bit of that slow start. I know one thing I have always seen is you out there, especially with guys like Jordan Pacheco and Alex Berg, almost every day working on your swings, taking extra batting practice. Speak about how that came about and how much that's been helpful for guys like you and Jordan Pacheco.
Yeah, it's crucial. You know, preparation is everything. You know, this game is so mental and tough to keep control on in the mental aspect. But if you prepare yourself, if you're going through the right process, you can allow yourself to be more free in the game and not try to worry about the results, because you know that you did everything possible to make sure you're prepared for the game.
Although you guys didn't end up having a winning road trip, it seemed through a lot of it that the offense was really clicking and starting to gel together as one, top to bottom in the order. Do you guys feel like as a group you guys are more confident offensively when you step into the batter's box?
Yeah. Hitting is contagious. Everybody's starting to swing the bat really well. Sometimes you go through those skids where offense is clicking and pitching is not, and pitching is clicking and offense is not, and the key is to make sure that you get everything clicking at the same time.
How difficult is it to find that balance, find that exact situation where everything is clicking at once to reel off a few wins in a row?
Yeah, all it takes is one game, one good game where the pitching is dominating and offense is clicking. So once that happens, you get that feeling, and then the team just starts rolling. So hopefully we'll get that going as soon as we got this homestand and carry it into the road.
I know you've been here for a little while now, but still somewhat one of the newest Ducks on this roster. And obviously, you're a guy who's made it up to the major leagues. You won a World Series with the Boston Red Sox in 2013. Relive that experience for us, what it was like to getting to be a part of the World Series and get to celebrate on the field at Fenway Park.
I think it's a reason all us old guys keep playing. You know, it's a great feeling. It's probably one of the greatest moments of my life to be a part of that team and to be able to ride that, you know, parade with everybody else. And it's a reason why I'm still playing to this day. You know, I want another opportunity to get to do it again. It's like that sweet taste in your mouth. You don't never want it to go away, and when it does, you want to get it again.
Who were some of the guys you were particularly close with in that Red Sox clubhouse?
Oh, everybody. That was such an easy team to get along with. It's kind of like here. It's just a great clubhouse. You got a bunch of guys that are got real good personalities, real easy to get to know, and they let you in right away. I mean, Big Poppy was huge. Dustin Pedroia, everybody knows he's one of the greatest guys in the game. And, you know, we just had so many guys that were just awesome. And, you know, I learned a lot from them, how to be a ball player and also how to be confident as being a man.
But, of course, now you're playing here on Long Island, and I'm sure many Ducks fans are also Yankee fans. Have you gotten any flack from them yet?
No, not at all. Not yet, at least. I think sooner or later it's going to come out.
All right, fair enough. Well, Quinton, congratulations on the good game yesterday, and best of luck here in this 7-game homestand.
Thank you.
That is outfielder Quinton Berry of the Long Island Ducks. Well, the Ducks are out on the field. Congressman Peter King is here tonight. He is about to throw out a ceremonial first pitch Congressman Peter King, representing New York's 2nd District, heading out to the mound, and he's going to throw a ceremonial first pitch here before we get started in today's game. And while that takes place, let's take a look at the pitching matchup for tonight's game. For the Long Island Ducks, right-hander John Brownell will get things going for this four-game series. Again, a crucial one for the Ducks, who enter play 2.5 games in back of first place in the Liberty Division. And they will turn to their ace here in the series opener, who has made 17 starts this year. Brownell 8-2 with a 3.20 ERA, and he is coming off of a victory against these Bridgeport Bluefish this past Saturday up at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Right-hander threw 5 innings of 1-run ball. He allowed just 5 hits, did not walk a batter for the first time since June the 9th, and in addition, 5 strikeouts in the start for Brownell. So he is coming off of a win in his most recent outing. In fact, he has also won 3 of his past 4 starts. And on the other side, he'll be facing left-hander Manny Parra, who is going to be making his Bridgeport Bluefish debut, a former major leaguer who is 34 years old, just recently signed with the Bluefish, pitched in 322 games during his major league career, 74 of which were starts, and he was 29-41 with a 4.90 ERA, spent 8 seasons in the big leagues from 2007 to 2010, as well as 2012 with the Milwaukee Brewers, and from 2013 to 2015 with the Cincinnati Reds, where he was teammates with Long Island Ducks right-hander Alfredo Simon. So a look at the pitching matchup tonight. A right-hander for the Ducks, a left-hander for the Bluefish. Now time to look at the starting lineups for the two teams this evening. For the Bluefish, who are managed by Luis Rodriguez, Darby Myers is going to lead things off. He is the center fielder. Batting second and at shortstop, Luis Hernandez. Jose Cuevas, the third baseman, will hit third. And in the cleanup spot, the first baseman, Sean Burrows. Jonathan Galvez will bat fifth. He will serve as the designated hitter. In the sixth spot is the left fielder, that is Daniel Fields. Gustavo Molina will do the catching at bat seventh. Hitting eighth at second base is Tony Abreu. And rounding out the order is the right fielder, and that is Wellington Dotel. On the other side for Kevin Baez is Long Island Ducks. Quentin Berry back in the lineup. He will lead things off and play right field. Delta Cleary Jr. bats second and plays center field. The three hitter is the first baseman, and that is Jordan Pacheco. Mark Krause hits in the cleanup spot, and he is the left fielder. Ruben Gotay will get the half day as the DH. He is going to bat fifth. The sixth hitter is the second baseman, Elmer Reyes. Alex Berg will do the catching tonight. He will bat in the number 7 spot. Hitting 8th and playing 3rd base is going to be the 3rd baseman, and that is Giovanni Alfonso. Rounding out the order for the Long Island Ducks is their shortstop, and that is Dan Lyons. So that's the look at the starting lineups for both the Bluefish and the Ducks. First game of a 4-game weekend series here at the beginning of August. Second time the Bluefish are visiting Bethpage Ballpark this season. The Ducks took 2 of 3 from Bridgeport back in June. So we are just about ready to go. In June, the Ducks played 3 games up in Bridgeport. Actually, it ended up being a 4-game series because of a rainout, and then 3 here on Long Island in a span of a week. And they're doing the same here up in Bridgeport last weekend and here on Long Island this weekend. First pitch in for a strike from John Brownell. We begin at 6:36 p.m. here on this beautiful Thursday evening. And now the 0-1, popped up in the air, left side of the infield. Dan Lyons, the shortstop, goes back along the left field line, reaches up and makes the catch as he backstrikes. And there's the first out of the ballgame.
Temperature of tonight's ballgame is 77 degrees.
77 degrees, the official first pitch temperature here at Bethpage Ballpark. A nice, comfortable evening for baseball. Wind blowing stiffly from right to left tonight.
Batting in the second position, the shortstop, number 2, Luis Hernandez, number 2.
So that will bring Luis Hernandez to the plate with the bases empty and 1 out. Myers was hitting 339 with 4 homers and 36 RBIs. And here Hernandez smacks the first offering from Brownell in a right field for a base hit. So a 1 out single. And Hernandez is on, first base runner of the night for Bridgeport. Hernandez came in at 279 with 3 homers and 29 runs batted in.
Jose Cuevas, number 11.
So, with 1 on and 1 out, Jose Cuevas, the third baseman, is going to step up to the plate, and he will bat from the right side. Cuevas comes in hitting 265 on the year for Bridgeport, and this is a Bluefish team that hits the ball well. They lead the Atlantic League with a 283 batting average, tied with the Lancaster Barnstormers. We saw what their offense could do this past weekend. First pitch, breaking ball, misses outside for ball one. Bluefish rallied back from a 6-0 deficit to win on Friday night in the series opener, and then they rallied back from a 7-0 deficit in the eighth inning on Sunday for an 8-7 victory that gave the Bluefish a series win. A stunning loss for Long Island on that Sunday afternoon. 1-0, big breaking ball that hits the outside corner for a strike and evens things up at 1-1. Magic Cuevas hitting .265, 6 home runs, 40 RBIs for Bridgeport, who just dropped 2 of 3 down in Waldorf, Maryland, to the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs this week, following their series with the Ducks. Long Island, meanwhile, dropped 2 of 3 on the road to the York Revolution and went 2-4 on their 6-game road trip. 1-1, fastball cut on and missed. That was that cut fastball from Brownell over the outside corner, and way late on it was Cuevas. So Brownell ahead in the count at 1-2. Fans continuing to file in on this Thursday night for the start of a 7-game homestand for the Ducks and their first home series in the month of August, where they will be home for the vast majority of the month. Brownell gets the sign and comes set. Runner leads from first, and he goes for second. 1-2 is fouled straight back. Hit and run on there for the Bluefish. And Brownell delivered a high fastball to Cuevas that he fouled back to the screen. So back to first base will head Hernandez. And he does have some speed. The shortstop 11 for 13 in the stolen base department this year. So that'll be another 1-2 from Brownell. Right-hander set at the belt, kicks and comes home. Runner doesn't go this time, and the breaking ball taken on the inside corner for strike three. So Jose Cuevas goes down looking, just staring down at home plate after that pitch. I don't know if he was upset with himself for not swinging or if he was upset with the call from home plate umpire Tom Gandolfo.
Batting in the fourth position for the Bluefish, the first placement. Number 15,
Sean. Oh, a two down and the base is empty. And a runner at first, excuse me. That is going to bring up Sean Burrows. Let's go over the defensive alignment for the Ducks. Mark Krause gets the start in left field tonight. Delta Cleary Jr. is in center. And the right fielder, Quinton Berry. Ducks are playing Burrows to go the opposite way. Krause way over to his right, closer to the line. And Cleary Jr. shaded way over towards left center. First pitch from Brownell to Burrows. On the way, Burrows takes the fastball upstairs for ball one. On the infield for the Ducks, Giovanni Alfonso starts at third base. Dan Lyons is the shortstop. Second baseman is Elmer Reyes, and Jordan Pacheco over at first base holding on the runner. Alex Berg does the catching behind home plate for right-hander John Brownell in his sixth season with the Long Island Ducks. 1-0. And that fastball at the knees over the inside corner for a called strike on Burrows. He was the count of 1-1. Burrows hitting .340 on the season for Bridgeport. 2 home runs, 29 runs batted in, a former Duck. Spent parts of 2015 and 2016 with Long Island. Be a 1-ball, 1-strike delivery. Brownell delivers, runner goes, and this is fisted out in the air to right field. Quinton Berry jogs in a couple steps to make the catch, and the side retired here in the opening inning. So for the Bluefish, no runs, one hit, and they leave a man on base. We've played a half an inning here at Bethpage Ballpark. Bluefish nothing, and the Ducks coming to bat.
Hey fans, this is pitcher John Brownell, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Long Island's Ford Giant is celebrating its 60th year anniversary. Stop by Sayville Ford to check out their state-of-the-art showroom featuring enclosed service drives, luxurious customer lounge, and a larger selection to choose from. Get giant savings on hundreds of new and used vehicles in stock. Sayville Ford's 60th anniversary celebration is going on now. Visit SaylvilleFord.com or download the Sayville Ford app today to learn more about Sayville Ford's 60th anniversary savings. Call 631-589-4800 today.
Bethpage Ballpark is a great place to watch a ball game, so why not do so from some of the best seats in the house? The Ducks are proud to present the brand new Long Island Ducks Beer Garden. Open for all fans on nights when the Smokin' Owl's party deck has not been reserved, the Beer Garden will feature a variety of frosty draft and bottled brews, as well as several food choices. The area has been decked out with bar rail seating and Ducks branded furniture to provide a comfortable atmosphere for everyone. Be sure to stop by and check out the brand new Long Island Ducks Beer Garden on your next visit to the ballpark. We move to the bottom of the first inning. No score here at Bethpage Ballpark. Manny Parra, the left-hander and former major leaguer, on the mound for Bridgeport, getting set to make his Atlantic League debut. And he'll be facing former major leaguers in Quentin Berry and Jordan Pacheco in this inning, along with center fielder Delta Cleary Jr. Fans, a reminder that every walk by a Ducks batter this season is brought to you by City MD Urgent Care. There are over 15 City MD locations across Long Island. Need a doctor? Just walk in. City MD Urgent Care offers the comprehensive quality care that you need the moment that you need it. So, here is the left-handed hitting Quentin Berry to lead things off for the Ducks, coming off of his great night last night. A thank you to him for joining us on the pregame show today to talk about how he has been feeling at the plate of late. Good to see him back in the lineup after a brief four-game absence with a strained quad. First pitch. And a fastball here from Parra hits the outside corner for strike one. Matchup of former big league southpaws here in Manny Parra and Quentin Berry. Berry comes in hitting 211 on the season for the Ducks. No homers, two RBIs. And he swings and misses. The pitch diving down in the zone. So Parra quickly jumps in front at nothing and two. Bluefish wearing their alternate camouflage uniforms. Just says Fish on the front, not Bluefish, just Fish. The camouflage on the main part of the jersey with the navy blue sleeves. 0-2, and Berry lays off the high fastball this time, ball one. Ducks, meanwhile, are in their home white uniforms with the orange logo on the front, the green number on the front and the back, and the black pinstripes on both the jersey and the pants. So the count 1-2 here on Berry. Hara kicks and comes home, and Berry swings at the breaking ball, lifts it in the air to center. Backing up and going to his right, Darby Myers. And in left center, he'll make the catch to retire Berry for the first
back
out.
In second position, Logan Lux, center fielder number 5, Delta Cleary Jr. And baseball fans, during this past road trip, Delta accomplished a milestone. He received and got his 1,000th baseball hit in his career. Congratulations, Delta, on accomplishing that big milestone.
So a nice touch there from the Long Island Ducks as they congratulate Delta Cleary Jr. for his 1,000th career hit, which he picked up on Monday night with a first pitch leadoff single in the first inning against the Revolution. He swings first pitch here and misses at the breaking ball for strike one. So a nice hand from the fans here at Bethpage Ballpark and a great acknowledgement by Ducks public address announcer Bob O'Tone. 0-1 on Cleary Jr., switch hitter from the right side. Parra deals and Cleary Jr. lays off the high fastball. That'll even things up at 1-1. 249 average on the year for Cleary Jr. Two homers, 27 driven in. And he lays off another high fastball from Parra, who's throwing the ball hard here in the early going. Living mostly with fastballs. 2-1 on Cleary Jr. Jordan Pacheco, the righty hitter, is next. Just two lefties in the lineup against Parra. And that's the leadoff hitter Berry and the cleanup hitter Kraus. Angelo Sanko getting the night off for the Ducks. 2-1, breaking ball cut on and missed. Got Cleary Jr. to chase down and in for strike two. That'll even things up. Ducks return back home following their road trip. Thus far, the Ducks at 23-22 here at home. Bluefish have played well on the road this year at 25-22. And the 2-2 is swinging a miss, strike three. As Cleary Jr. chasing the pitch downstairs. First strike out of the night for the southpaw Parra. And with two away, that'll leave it up to Jordan Pacheco.
Hitting in the third position, Long Island Ducks first baseman number 15, Jordan Pacheco, number 15.
The defensive lineup tonight for the Bluefish, Daniel Field starts in left field, Darby Myers is in center, and Wellington Dotel around in right. On the infield from left to right, Jose Cuevas is the third baseman, Luis Hernandez the shortstop. Tony Abreu starts at second base, Sean Burrows is the first baseman, and Gustavo Molina does the catching behind home plate for Manny Parra. Delivers a first pitch fastball strike over the outside corner to Pacheco, and it's nothing and one. Jordan Pacheco comes in hitting 263 on the season. He's got three home runs and 21 runs batted in. Parra out of the windup, and the 0-1. Fastball, that catches the inside corner this time. And the count quickly, nothing and two as Parra throwing strikes here in the early going. And getting ahead in the count on these Ducks hitters. Left-hander trying to retire the side in order. Now the 0-2. Pacheco a swing and a miss for strike three. Foul tipped it into the glove of the catcher Molina. Two strikeouts at a 1-2-3 bottom of the first for Parra. Ducks go in order. We go to the second. No score on Long Island.
Hey, fans. This is shortstop Dan Lyons, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
PSEG Long Island is making things work for you with over 10 energy efficiency programs that can help you save on your monthly electric bill. From our free online energy analyzer and in-home energy assessments to rebates on energy-efficient air conditioning, even discounts on LED light bulbs. Helping you save on electricity is our job. What to do with your savings?
Flight 85 now boarding for the magic of Orlando.
Is entirely up to you. Visit PSEGLINY.com/save money. Just one more way PSEG Long Island is making things work for you.
Take your group out to the ball game this season and enjoy all the fun of Ducks baseball at discounted prices with the picnic area, luxury suites, the smoking out party deck, and so much more. Bringing your group to the game will be an unforgettable experience. The Ducks even offer opportunities to sing the national anthem, serve as the Ridgewood Savings Bank color guard, be the Nickelock Dream Team, put on a pregame performance, or shag fly balls during Ducks batting practice. To book your outing today, call 631-940-3825 and ask for the group sales department. Long Island Ducks Baseball. Good times every time.
Second inning coming up at Bethpage Ballpark. No score between the Long Island Ducks and the Bridgeport Bluefish. Time for the Ducks Health Report, and that's brought to you by Island Shore Physical Therapy, the official therapist of the Long Island Ducks. Good news for Long Island. Anthony Vega was reinstated to the active list yesterday after missing the final game in Bridgeport and the series in New York. After suffering a facial contusion, got hit in the face with a baseball in Bridgeport on a stolen base. But he is back and available for Long Island. They'd like to avoid using him if they could right away as he continues to recover, but he is active and available off the bench for Kevin Baez. Lou Ford is still out day-to-day as he recovers from a hamstring injury. First pitch here to Jonathan Galvez is a breaking ball from Brownell upstairs, ball one. Unfortunately, the Ducks did have to place left-hander Yuri De La Rosa on the disabled list today as he continues to deal with some arm troubles that have plagued him throughout the course of this season. 1-0 is a breaking ball outside for ball two, and in another transaction, infielder Jake McGuigan, who the Ducks acquired from the New Britain Bees back on Monday, was traded back to New Britain after the game last night to complete the earlier trade. There's a breaking ball strike over the inside corner from Brownell to Galvez. 2-1 the count. Galvez hitting .270 on the year. He's got 10 home runs and 44 runs batted in. Now the 2-1. Driven in the air to right, heading into the corner. Long run back for Mark Krause. He won't get there. And this will one hop and go over the wall for a ground rule double. So Jonathan Galvez, I should say, going the opposite way in a right field for the two base hit. The second hit of the ball game for Bridgeport for Galvez's 15th double of the season. So Galvez is at second base with nobody out. And now the aforementioned Daniel Fields, the lefty swinger, will step to the plate for the Bluefish. Brownell looks in for the sign. Alex Berg flashes what he wants in the first pitch on the way from Brownell. Breaking ball hit on the ground to the right side. Elmer Reyes in the hole makes a nice pickup. Spins and throws to first for the out. Good play by Elmer Reyes. But Fields does get the job done. He moves Galvez over to third base with only one out. And that will bring up the catcher, Gustavo Molina. So Fields retired. He came in hitting .304 with 10 homers and 46 runs batted in. So the one away here is Gustavo Molina, the former major leaguer and former Southern Maryland Blue Crab. Here in his first season with the Bluefish, he will come to the plate. Ducks will bring the infield in all the way around to cut off the run at home. Brownell comes set at the belt. And his first pitch is a big breaking ball, but it just missed low. and the count 1-0. Brownell started against these Bluefish this past Saturday up in Connecticut. The first of the two Ducks wins on the road trip as Long Island won it 11-1. 1-0. Breaking ball lined off of the glove of Brownell, and it's caught by Reyes. Unbelievable. An absolute rocket off the bat of Molina. It clipped Brownell and went to the second baseman, Reyes, who was ranging up the middle, and somehow he made the catch. What a play. A line drive off of Brownell, a 1-4 putout, and there are two away. Kevin Baez came out of the dugout along with trainer Dottie Pitchford. Baez wanted to make sure that his starter was okay. I'm not sure exactly where it caught him. It looked like it either nipped his glove or maybe the side. And then ricocheted right to Reyes. That's the second time in a span of a week, not even a full week, that we've seen the Ducks do that, have a line drive, hit off of a pitcher, and get caught by Reyes. It happened to Matt Larkins in York on Monday night. First pitch here to Tony Abreu is a breaking ball that misses up and in for ball one. Abreu hitting 305 on the year, three homers, 40 runs batted in. Gustavo Molina couldn't believe it, had no idea how that ball was caught by Reyes. 1-0, breaking ball back to the mound. Brownell stabs it on one hop, will throw it over to Jordan Pacheco at first. And John Brownell, like a magnet on there on the mound, had two balls come back at him, one a line drive off of him that was caught by Reyes, and another on the comebacker, and a nice job by the righty to work around the leadoff ground rule double. So in the inning, no runs, one hit. Bluefish leave a runner at third base, and we will head to the bottom of the second inning. Still no score.
Hey, fans, this is outfielder Delta Cleary Jr., and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Hey, Ducks fans, the official hotel of the Long Island Ducks is the Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island. It's centrally located on the north shore of Long Island and offers a home away from home for both business and leisure guests. The Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island features an indoor pool, 24-hour business center, a fitness center, and complimentary Wi-Fi in all guest rooms. Enjoy the contemporary American cuisine at the Fountain Grill Restaurant or grab a quick bite to eat at Cafe Pronto. And best of all, it's only minutes away from Bethpage Ballpark. The Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island, the official hotel of the Long Island Ducks. Call 631-231-1100 today. That's 631-231-1100.
Baseball fans, the Long Island Ducks mobile app has officially arrived. Powered by Clear Vision Apps, it's your one-stop shop for all things Ducks baseball. Buy tickets straight from your mobile device. Receive game status updates with push notifications. Check out up-to-the-minute news and scores and interact with the Ducks on social media. Best of all, it's free. Download the Ducks mobile app today by visiting the App Store on your Apple-powered device or Google Play on your Android-powered device. The Long Island Ducks mobile app, with you wherever you flock to. John Brownell works around a leadoff ground rule double by Jonathan Galvez. We go to the bottom of the second, still no score. And fans, a reminder that there's no better time than right now to sign up the young Ducks fan in your life at the Bethpage Federal Credit Union Ducks Kids Club. Children 14 and under can receive exciting gifts, discounts on merchandise, and unique experiences that only come with being a member. Sign up today by visiting liducks.com or by calling 631-940-3825. So Mark Krause will lead things off for the Ducks as we move to the bottom half of the second inning. Manny Parra, who retired the side in order quickly in the top half of the first, will head back to the mound once again. First pitch on the way here to the lefty. Krause is taken inside for ball one. Good eye by the Ducks left fielder, who comes in riding an 18-game on-base streak. He has hits in 17 of those 18 games. Parra's 1-0, and again he missed inside with a fastball. So Krause jumps in front of the count at 2-0. And we'll see how long Parra can go here today. Not sure if he's going to be on any sort of limit. Again, this is his first outing in a Bluefish uniform. but he has made 11 relief appearances this season. Fastball here is off the plate, outside. And now 3-0. He started the year with AAA Iowa in the Chicago Cubs organization after missing all of last season due to Tommy John surgery. Had a 14.09 ERA, an 0-1 record, and one save in 11 games out of the bullpen. 3-0 to Krause, taken all the way, and that is inside, ball four. So Manny Parra, who was lights out in the first inning, misses with four straight to begin the second. And that walk brought to you by CityMD Urgent Care. There are over 15 CityMD locations across Long Island. Need a doctor, just walk in. So a leadoff walk to Krause, who has drawn more walks than anybody in a Ducks uniform this year. He is on to begin the second, and here is the switch hitting go tie from the right side. First pitch from Manny Parra. Fastball hits the outside corner. And the count nothing and one. Go tie hitting 268 on the season. Two home runs, 13 runs batted in. Now the 0-1, swing and a miss. Gotai was out in front of it. Good hack on what would have been a strike, but now nothing and two. So Gotai quickly behind in the count. Krause continues to lead at first. Krause 3-for-3 in the stolen base department this year. Parra looking over, now deals to the plate, and Gotai takes downstairs. Would not chase out of the zone from the left-hander. And now the count of 1-2. I mentioned Parra, a former major leaguer, first made it up to the big leagues with the Milwaukee Brewers in 2007. He pitched in 9 games, 2 of which were starts, and was 0-1 with a 3.76 ERA that year. 1-2. Fastball is downstairs. And that'll even things up at 2-2 most recently. Was in the big leagues with the Reds in 2015, pitched in 40 games of relief that year, and was 1-2, had a 3.90 earned run average. Krause leads from first, 2-2 to Ruben Gotai. Here's the pitch. Gotai hits a ground ball to short, should be two. Flipped to second for one, and on to first, double play. So Ruben Gotai grinds into the 6-4-3 double play, and just like that, two down and the base is empty for Long Island. So with two down, Elmer Reyes will come to the plate. Reyes batting in the sixth spot for Long Island tonight. And Manny Parra works around the leadoff walk to get the double play. Now with two down, here's Reyes from the right side. At four straight righties, two up now for the Ducks. First pitch, and that is taken outside for ball one. Reyes comes in hitting 288 on the season for Long Island. 3 home runs, 37 runs batted in. 1-0, swinging a foul tip into the glove of Molina, the catcher. That'll even things up at 1-1. Wind continues to blow from right to left. Lights slowly coming on here at Bethpage Ballpark as the sun continues to set beyond the third base stands. 1-1, a breaking ball. That catches the outside corner for strike two. So Manny Parra ahead at 1-2 and trying to face the minimum 3 batters for the second inning in a row. Kick and the delivery to the plate. And Reyes takes the fastball down in the dirt, blocked there by Molina. Not leaving the count up at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Manny Parra, by the way, no relation to Gerardo Parra, the other former other major leaguer. He from Venezuela, whereas Manny Parra out of Carmichael, California. Reyes a swing and a foul ball, just caught off another, fighting it off to stay alive. So those two have no relation. But both have made it up to the highest level of professional baseball, Major League Baseball. And now Manny here with the Bridgeport Bluefish, first time pitching in the Atlantic League. 2-2 delivery, swinging a foul ball back behind the plate upstairs. And the ball caroms back down below.
Reyes doing a good job fighting off a couple tough two-strike pitches from the left-hander, keeping the count even. And if he reaches the catcher, Alex Berg will be the next hitter for the Ducks. Here's the 2-2. Fastball on the inside corner, strike three called. So Reyes takes a called strike three over the inside corner, third strikeout for Parra. And the Ducks are retired here in the second inning. No runs, no hits, a walk, but the bases left empty. We go to inning number three, still scoreless on Long Island.
Hey fans, this is outfielder Angelo Sanko, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Going way back is Joe Holden, and he is looking up, and that one is headed to field five at Robert Moses. The waves are gnarly, and the Ducks have tied it at one.
That was another home run for the Ducks. And Duck fans, what's more fun than a home run that helps the Ducks win a game? How about a homer that helps the community win? Chappie's Funeral Home and the Long Island Ducks have once again teamed up for the Chappie's Home Run Challenge. If the Ducks hit 100 homers this season, Chappie's Funeral Home will donate $5,000 to the Quacker Jack Foundation. So every time a Ducks hitter goes deep this season, watch for the Chappie's Challenge Home Run count on the scoreboard. And if we reach 100, we're all a winner. Chappie's Funeral Home, where caring for others is a family tradition.
Can't get enough of the Long Island Ducks? Well, now you can get even more inside info on your favorite hometown team through Facebook and Twitter. The Ducks are constantly updating fans through social media with scores, transactions, ballpark promotions, and much more. You can even win great prizes. All you'll need to do is make a free account on Facebook and Twitter, and then visit us at Facebook.com/LIDucks and Twitter.com/LIDucks. Think you're Long Island's biggest Ducks fan? Get connected now.
New York Sports Day is one of the largest independent New York sports news sources out there for coverage of the Long Island Ducks, the Mets and Yankees, major and minor league baseball, football, basketball, hockey, and soccer. Visit www.nysportsday.com. New York Sports Day, your independent Gotham sports news source. Third inning coming up here at Bethpage Ballpark. Neither side has played it a run through the first two. Bridgeport with two hits, the Ducks with a walk. And it'll be the nine-hitter and right fielder Wellington Dotel to begin things for Bridgeport. First pitch, swing and a miss, way late on the fastball. And the count nothing and one. Dotel began the year in Mexico and is 3-for-18 since rejoining the Bluefish. No homers and two runs batted in. Wide open stance at the plate, the 0-1. Swinging a drive in the air to left, hit pretty well. But Mark Krause was playing him deep, and he's there to make the catch to retire Dotel for the first out. So shocking to see Wellington Dotel hitting in the ninth spot of the order. Back in 2015 was the Atlantic League's Player of the Year, one year after Long Island's Lou Ford won it. And he's been such a force in the Bluefish lineup over his last couple seasons, but off to a little bit of a slow start, and this Bluefish lineup packed with a lot of good hitters. Back to the top of the order we go for Darby Myers, the speedy center fielder who popped a short his first time up. First pitch from Brownell is at the belt for a strike, and the count nothing at one. Myers off to a red-hot start this season, .339 batting average, and he's stolen 24 bases in 31 attempts. The 0-1, breaking ball driven in the air deep but foul down the left field line. And Brownell now ahead nothing and two. Myers yesterday was 2-for-5 at the plate in Bridgeport's 5-4 walk-off loss to the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. L.J. Hose had the game-winning hit, part of a three-hit, three-RBI day for Southern Maryland. 0-2, Myers takes the cutter outside. And off the glove of Berg, no harm, no foul, though, with the bases empty, 1-2. Giovanni Alfonso plays right along the line at third. Jordan Pacheco well off the bag at first. Now the 1-2 is a cutter down and away. No chase from Myers, and he evens up the count. Luis Hernandez, the shortstop, will be next. Brownell out of the windup, and his 2-2. Breaking ball, just getting a piece of it was Myers to foul it off. Got fooled on the pitch, but just got a little bit. And he was able to stay alive. We'll do it again at 2-2 here. First of four this weekend between these two teams. The Ferry Cup Series, if the Ducks sweep this series, they will earn the Ferry Cup Series once again. 2-2. Driving the air to left. Krause on the run in. He'll have to play it on a hop. It's a base hit for Darby Myers as he singles out in the left field. First hit of the day for Myers. Third for Bluefish. Third for the Bluefish. And with one on and one out, that'll bring up Luis Hernandez. Well, Brownell has been giving up hits this year. That's nothing new. He, throughout the course of his career, will tend to give up about a hit per inning. He's had 105 hits this year in 104 innings coming in, but does not walk many, just 34 walks this season, and has struck out 66. He's 8-2 with a 3.20 ERA, which ranks fifth in the Atlantic League. First pitch to Hernandez. He squares to bunt and ends up pulling back and taking a breaking ball low, 1-0. Hernandez singled to right on the first pitch he saw from Brownell back in the first. Brownell's 8 wins tied for third in the league. Frank Gailey and Michael Nix tied for the league lead with 9, so a win tonight for Brownell would pull him into a tie for the league lead. 1-0. Hernandez takes the breaking ball on the outside corner for strike one. Yesterday, Hernandez was 1-for-4 at the plate, hit his third home run of the year, a solo homer for the Bluefish as part of their game down in Southern Maryland. Myers takes his lead. 1-1 from Brownell. Kicks and comes home. Myers bluffs. This one chopped towards short. Backing up on it. Lyons, and he can't come up with it. Bounced and went off his glove. Safe at first is going to be Hernandez. And we'll see how that scored. It took a weird hop. So it'll be an error on Dan Lyons, his 16th error of the season. Ball just bounced and Lyons could not come up with it cleanly. So now runners at first and second with one away. And Jose Cuevas going to come to the plate. Ducks made two errors in each of their last two games and have been struggling a little bit defensively of late. Here's Jose Cuevas from the right side, first pitch. Cuevas swings and misses at the off-speed pitch for strike one. Brownell will have to bear down again. He got out of a jam in the second inning when he allowed a ground rule double to begin the inning. And here is allowed a single and an error with one out. That I put runners at first and second. That was going to be a tough play for Lyons with the speed of Hernandez. But might have had a chance had he come up with it. Now the 0-1, breaking ball, hit on the ground to the left side. Alfonso to his left field, goes to second one, on to first, double play. Nicely turned, 5-4-3 around the horn, double play off the bat of Jose Cuevas. And again, Brownell escapes trouble in the third inning. No runs, one hit, one error because of the double play, only one left on base. And after 2.5 innings of play, it is still scoreless here at Bethpage Ballpark.
Hey fans, this is pitcher Matt Larkins, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Oh, I love it. The color of my new Nicolat patio is so vibrant. It's unlike anything I've ever seen.
You're welcome. I'm just going to go finish that Nicolat walkway now.
Make your pavers vivid Nicolat pavers. The best looking, most vibrant pavers with the most 3 color blends in the industry. Featuring Nicolat's exclusive paver shield and color blending technology with color throughout and guaranteed not to fade. Live life in color with Nicolat. Visit Nicolat.com.
Have your birthday at the ballpark this season and celebrate with the flock. Kona Ice birthday party packages with the Long Island Ducks are now available. Each package includes 10 box seats, a commemorative birthday t-shirt and autographed baseball, a pizza and Kona Ice party in the Hebrew National picnic area, and so much more. Best of all, the birthday child will stand on the dugout while the entire crowd sings happy birthday. Reserve your party today by calling the group sales department at 631-940-3825. Kona Ice birthday parties with the Long Island Ducks, a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Yeah.
Well, fans, when the Ducks turned that 5-4-3 around the horn double play to end the top half of the third inning, the final out of the inning was the 15th out of tonight's ball game. And did you know that a 15-minute phone call to Geico could save you 15% or more on your car insurance? Get a free quote today. Call 1-800-947-AUTO. That's 1-800-947-AUTO or visit geico.com. So good work thus far from John Brownell. He has given up three hits, but he has worked out of a couple jams. Runner at second, nobody out in the top half of the second inning. And runners at first and second with one out in the top of the third. And so Bridgeport remains scoreless, the Ducks scoreless. And as we go to the bottom of the third, Alex Berg will begin things against Manny Parra. First pitch on the way, and Berg takes a breaking ball over the inside corner. Good bite on that curveball from the left-hander. Nothing and one on Alex Berg, who comes in hitting .216 on the year for the Ducks. Here's the 0-1. Driven deep but foul down the right field line. Not sure if it would have had home run distance, but he hit it towards that handicap ramp down the right field line. And Berg was right on that pitch a little bit late, though, and that's why it went foul. So nothing and two the count here on the Ducks catcher. Eight homers, 24 runs batted in for Berg. He'll be followed by Alfonso and Lyons in the third inning. 0-2, swing and a miss, late on the fastball, strike three. And Manny Parra already with his fourth strikeout of the night. One away here in the bottom of the third.
Batting in the eighth position, Long Island's third baseman, number 6, Giovanni Alfonso, number 6.
Parra again missed all of last season due to Tommy John surgery, which he suffered at the end of spring training. The year prior, we mentioned he spent 40 games in the big leagues with the Reds and made two appearances as well, pitching 2 2/3 scoreless innings for AAA Louisville. Giovanni Alfonso takes the first pitch in for a strike. And the count nothing and one on Alfonso, hitting an even .300 on the year. Two homers, 29 runs batted in. And the 0-1 breaking ball hit on the ground is short. Luis Hernandez is there. And his throw across is in time. A strikeout, a ground out. And two outs recorded on five pitches thus far for Manny Parra.
Getting in the ninth position, Long Island Ducks shortstop, number 12, Dan Lyons, number 12.
And Manny Parra now working with another former major leaguer who is on the coaching staff for the Bluefish, and that is their pitching coach for this year, Rich Garces. El Guapo, former major leaguer, specifically with the Boston Red Sox. Dan Lyons to the plate from the right side. First pitch on the way, and Lyons takes the fastball just off the outside corner. 1-0 in favor of the Ducks shortstop, who comes in at .248 on the season. Five home runs, 27 runs batted in. 1-0. Popped up in the air, foul back behind the plate on the fastball down in the zone. And that will even things up at 1-1. No score, bottom of the third inning. Series opener on Long Island. And the 1-1 is a fastball off the inside corner. Good eye from the Duck shortstop. Now the count 2-1. Parra was originally a draft pick of the Brewers, 26th round pick in 2001. Out of American River College in Sacramento. 2-1, another pitch out of the zone, this time a fastball high and outside. So it is 3-1 on Lyons, and if he reaches with two outs, Quentin Berry will get a second opportunity to come up and bat. Good hitters count here for Lyons. And a 3-1 from Parra. Down in the zone, ball 4, good eye from Lyons, he works the count full and draws the walk, or excuse me, to 3-1 and draws the walk. Second free pass issued by the left-hander. And another walk brought to you by CityMD Urgent Care. There are over 15 CityMD locations across Long Island. Need a doctor, just walk in. So Lyons is on with two away, and that will bring Quentin Berry up to the plate, the Ducks' right fielder. We'll see if Lyons tries to take off to get into scoring position at any point. He's 4-for-5 in the stolen base department this year. First pitch on the way to Berry. Breaking ball. That is in. Belt high for a strike. And the count nothing at one. A little tougher for the Ducks runners to try and get to second on a steal with a lefty throwing. Now the 0-1. Hara kicks and throws over to first base. DeChase lines back. The throw goes off the glove of Burrows and comes down the right field line. Lyons goes to second. He's going to round second and head to third. And the throw in from Burrows is going to be cut off by the shortstop Hernandez. So an error there on the pitcher, Manny Parra, on his throw over to first base. That got away from the first baseman, Sean Burrows, who had to try and reach across lines to get it and could not. A break there for Long Island. And on the error, the Ducks now have a runner at third base with two away. And Quentin Berry still with the 0-1 count.
No, I don't remember it either.
0-1, swing and a miss. A breaking ball down in the zone. He actually might have foul tipped it. That's the ball down in the batter's box, so Berry will flip it over to the first base side. And Parra with a count of nothing and two. So each side has now committed an error in this game. First error with the Bluefish, obviously, for Parra. From the stretch, here's the 0-2. Left-hander kicks and fires to the plate, and Berry hits a ground ball to the right side. Couple hops for Sean Burrows. He'll take it to the bag himself. And the side retired for Long Island. So Dan Lyons draws the two-out walk, makes it to third on the error, but nothing across for Long Island. No runs, no hits, one error, and one left. Three innings complete, no score here at Bethpage Ballpark.
Hey, fans, this is infielder Elmer Reyes, and you're listening to Duck Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
M&V Limousines is the official bus company of the Long Island Ducks. Family-owned and operated, they've been in the business for over 24 years. M&V Limousines offers coach buses with Wi-Fi and restrooms, party buses, exotic limousines, and also recently acquired Hampton Luxury Liner with regular service from New York City to the Hamptons. They also offer a variety of vineyard tour options. Whether you're looking for transportation for weddings, proms, corporate outings, or long-distance trips, they've got the right vehicle for you. Visit their showroom in Comac or check them out online at mvlimo.com. M&V Limousines and Hampton Luxury Liner, the official bus company of the Long Island Ducks.
Family fun every time.
Beautiful evening for baseball.
Big action every time.
He reaches up. It's gone!
Great value every time.
And the Ducks have won it 7-1.
The Ducks schedule is loaded with new promotions this season. And with an average ticket price of just $10 and free parking, there is no better value on Long Island. For game times and tickets, visit liducks.com. Long Island Ducks Baseball. Good times every time.
We take this game to the fourth inning. Scoreless pitcher's duel through the first three here on Long Island. John Brownell will go back to work and face the 4, 5, and 6 hitters in the Bluefish order. And as we hit the fourth inning, it is also time for our fourth inning trivia question, where we test your knowledge of the Long Island Ducks, the Atlantic League, and baseball as a whole. So I'll give you the question here as things begin in the fourth inning for the Bluefish at the plate. Sean Burrows, who popped out to right his first time up, will lead things off for Bridgeport. First pitch on the way from Brownell, and Burrows takes the breaking ball on the inside corner for strike one. Well, today's question will revolve around the Bluefish starter making his Atlantic League debut, Manny Parra. I mentioned a former big leaguer, of course. Split time in the majors with the Brewers and the Reds. 0-1, breaking ball, grounded foul, first base side. And the count quickly, nothing and two. Made 9 appearances in his first big league season in 2007, but did not get his first win until his second season, when he in fact got his first major league win in the first game he pitched in 2008, a 5-4 win over the San Francisco Giants at Miller Park in Milwaukee. He was a member of the Brewers at the time. Pitched 5 1/3 innings of 2-run ball, striking out 7 to get the win. Here Burrows, a line drive in the air to left. Mark Krause on the run, makes a sliding catch. Nice grab by Mark Krause in left field to rob Sean Burrows of the base hit. And there's the first out of the fourth. Nice grab there by Krause, one away. And that'll bring up the DH, Jonathan Galvez. So again, first big league win for Manny Parra came on April the 5th, 2008. The question: who was the pitcher who earned the save and Manny Parra's first big league win. And we will give you a hint. He would go on to play for the Long Island Ducks. First pitch, misses low for ball one. Former Brewer who would go on to play for the Long Island Ducks. We'll let you think about it. We'll give you the answer in the bottom half of the inning. 1-0 on Galvez, who stroked the ground rule double to right his first time up, leading off the second inning. Takes a breaking ball on the outside corner for a strike from Brownell, and that'll even things up at 1-1. Galvez got to second with nobody out, made it to third with one out, but was stranded there. 1-1, breaking ball, fouled into the dirt by Galvez. Brownell has had some good movement on his breaking ball thus far in the game. He throws that big looping 12-6 curveball and also has that good cut fastball that he oftentimes will use to try and get a strikeout. Quickly ahead of Galvez here at 1-2. Right-hander kicks and deals to the plate, and Galvez swings and crushes one to left center. Back goes Mark Krause into the gap. He won't get there. It is one hop and will go to the wall. Galvez to second base. He will round second and then put the brakes on. And Galvez with his second double of the night as he is on with one out in the fourth. Now up to 16 doubles on the year for Jonathan Galvez, who has hit one of the right field corner and now has hit one of the left center field gap. So Bluefish have had at least one hit in every inning against Brownell, four hits thus far. On the lefty swinging, Daniel Fields will come up for the second time tonight. Brownell has struck out one thus far, has yet to walk a batter. The first pitch on the way from the right-hander. Fields will take down and in. Good block at home plate by Berg. And the count 1-0. By the way, if you think you know our trivia question and want to get a special shout-out on the airwaves, leave a comment on our Facebook live stream or our YouTube stream. And if you're correct, we'll give you the shout-out here on the airwaves. 1-0, breaking ball, fouled off. Third base side into the seats. And that evens things up at 1-1. Fields grounded out to second base his first time up. That was back in the second inning. It moved Galvez over to third. Fields did not play in yesterday's game for the Bluefish. Had the afternoon off. It was actually the morning game, 11 o'clock in the morning down in Southern Maryland yesterday, a camp day. 1-1. Brownell fires, and Fields will swing and a miss. Good breaking ball, that curve. Chopping from about letter high down at the bottom of the zone. So Fields now behind at 1-2 as Brownell looks for out number two in the fourth inning.
Right.
The Ducks win tonight would give them an 8-6 lead over the Bluefish in the Ferry Cup series. A Bluefish win would even it up at 7. And again, if Long Island wins all four in this series, they will take home the Ferry Cup for a second straight year. 1-2, fastball upstairs, try to get Fields to chase, he would not. Long Island won the Ferry Cup trophy last year over these Bluefish. Won it up in Bridgeport.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
2-2 the count. Kicking the pitch. Breaking ball misses downstairs. Another block by Berg. So Brownell ahead in the count, trying to get Fields to chase twice. He would not. And now the count full at 3-2. Gustavo Molina, the catcher, waiting in the on-deck circle. Galvez with decent speed will take his lead off of second base. Lions playing behind him. 3-2 from John Brownell. Breaking ball rocketed in the air to center. That's hit well. Cleary Jr. racing back, turns at the wall, looks up, and you can forget it. A two-run home run over the wall in center field for Daniel Field. His 11th home run of the season. Bluefish break the scoreless tie, and they lead it 2-0. So back-to-back extra base hits off of John Brownell with one out here in the fourth. Fields with his 11th home run, RBIs 47 and 48, and he put a charge into that one in center. And so the Bluefish strike first and have the early lead.
Gustavo Molina, number 40.
for Brownell, the eighth home run he has allowed this season. Now with one out, the base is now empty. Here is the catcher, Gustavo Molina, who takes a strike on the outside corner. Brownell had gotten ahead of Fields at 1-2, trying to get him to chase a high fastball and a low breaking ball. He did not go after either, and then hit a breaking ball over the middle of the plate out to center. 0-1 is a weak ground ball to first, a squibber, and it goes through the legs of Jordan Pacheco and into right field. Pacheco was ranging over, and the ball went straight through his legs. And it went straight through into right field. I don't know if the ball just had enough English on it or if Pacheco overran it. But he raced over to try and get it. Didn't have to go too far. But went over to get it, and the ball went right through the wickets. So an error off the bat off of Gustavo Molina's bat. Reaching at first base is Molina as Pacheco cannot come up with it. And now runner at first base with one out. And up to the plate is going to step the second baseman, Tony Abreu. First pitch, and Abreu swings and misses on a fastball for strike one. Molina on first base does not have a ton of speed. Abreu grounded out back to the mound his first time up. Now the 0-1. Ground ball hit to the right side. That's going to get through for a base hit in between Pacheco and Reyes. And make it four straight Bluefish batters to reach with one out here in the fourth. And Bridgeport set up with runners at first and second with one away. And Wellington Dotel will now come to the plate. First, Billy Horn going to come out of the dugout to try and settle down his right-hander. So after the good start from Brownell to get out of some jams, he allows the two-run home run here in the fourth inning to Daniel Fields. Pacheco can't come up with a weak grounder to first off the bat of Molina. And now a single to right for Tony Abreu puts two on with one away. Horn has the quick chat with Brownell to try and settle him down. Bridgeport now out hitting Long Island 6-0 in this one. And the nine hitter and right fielder Wellington Dotel, who lined out to left field his first time up, will step back up to home plate. Sixth batter of the inning for Bridgeport. And the first pitch to Dotel is a fastball that missed up inside. 1-0 on Dotel. With an 0-1 pitch to left to begin the third inning. Next two batters then reached, but Brownell got the double play to get out of the trouble. Right-hander comes set. The runners lead from first and second. And the 1-0. Breaking ball again, missing up and inside. Now Dotel in the driver's seat at 2-0. Dotel had the day off yesterday for Bridgeport. Now 3 of 19 to begin his season for the Bluefish. Here comes the 2-0, kicking the pitch on the way. Dotel swings, rips this one in the left field, another base hit. To third base goes Molina, and ball was bobbled by Mark Krause. And now around third is Molina. He's going to come in to score. No RBI on that. It's going to be a base hit, and then scoring from third on the E7 is Molina, as Krause did not come up with it cleanly. Third error already committed by the Ducks. And it is now a 3-0 ball game. That run unearned anyway because Molina reached on the error by the first baseman. Ground ball hit to the left side, another base hit, this time by Darby Myers. Around third base coming in and scoring on the play is going to be Tony Abreu. Another RBI single, and it is now a 4-0 lead for Bridgeport. Things spiraling out of control here for John Brownell in his fourth inning. Bridgeport has now had six straight batters reach. A very similar feel to what happened up in Bridgeport on Sunday when the Ducks collapsed in the eighth inning and lost a 7-0 lead as Bridgeport won the game 8-7. So So again, a single for Dotel. No RBI is scoring on the error by Kraus. Was Molina. And then Abreu moved to second on the play. And Abreu scores on the RBI single by Darby Myers, who now has two hits. This is a line drive foul. First base side. Myers picks up the RBI, his 37th of the season. And Abreu scores. Dotel moves to second on that. Count quickly, nothing and two here on Luis Hernandez. Again, Brownell would love a ground ball to try and get a double play, but he is just looking for outs at this point. 0-2 from the righty. Runner goes. No, he bluffs. Looked like Dotel was going to take off, and he bluffed at second. The pitch missed low. And now the count 1-2. Brownell up to 57 yep. pitches here tonight, 41 of them for strikes. Dotel leads from second, and Myers from first with one down. 1-2 pitch, and again Brownell misses low, trying to get him to chase. He would not. Leaving things up at 2-2. We saw yesterday Alfredo Simon got off to a strong start through the first three innings. Lost it a little bit in the fourth, but managed to just give up one run, and then really fell apart in the fifth inning when he allowed the three-run home run that gave the Revolution, the 4-3 lead, and they would go on to win by that score. 2-2 delivery. And Hernandez a swing and a miss. Strike three. Throw down to third base in plenty of time. Dotel is out. Strike him out. Throw him out. Double play. Exactly what Brownell needed. And that'll end the inning. The damage done for the Bluefish. They pick up four runs in the inning on five hits, two errors, and one man left on base, because of the caught stealing. We will head to the bottom of the fourth, 4-0 in favor of Bridgeport.
Hey fans, this is infielder Giovanni Alfonso, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Long Island's Ford Giant is celebrating its 60th year anniversary. Stop by Sayville Ford to check out their state-of-the-art showroom featuring enclosed service drives, luxurious customer lounge, and a larger selection to choose from. Get giant savings on hundreds of new and used vehicles in stock. Sayville Ford's 60th anniversary celebration is going on now. Visit SaylvilleFord.com or download the Sayville Ford app today to learn more about Sayville Ford's 60th anniversary savings. Call 631-589-4800 today.
Bethpage Ballpark is a great place to watch a ball game, so why not do so from some of the best seats in the house? The Ducks are proud to present the brand new Long Island Ducks Beer Garden. Open for all fans on nights when the Smoking Owl's party deck has not been reserved, the Beer Garden will feature a variety of frosty draft and bottled brews, as well as several food choices. The area has been decked out with bar rail seating and Ducks branded furniture to provide a comfortable atmosphere for everyone. Be sure to stop by and check out the brand new Long Island Ducks Beer Garden on your next visit to the ballpark.
Ducks have some work to do now as they trail the Bridgeport Bluefish by the count of 4-0 as we go to the bottom half of the fourth inning. Been a little bit of a sloppy start for the Ducks. They have made three errors out in the field. In that inning, of the four runs that scored, three of them were earned. And again, in the inning, five hits, two errors, and a runner left for the Bluefish. So the Ducks offense will have to try and rally back in support of their starter. Meanwhile, they're just looking for hits at this point. Ducks are hitless through the first three innings. And Manny Parra will face Delta Cleary Jr. to begin the bottom half of the fourth inning. We'll also give you the answer to our fourth inning trivia question, where we tested your knowledge of the Long Island Ducks, the Atlantic League, and baseball as a whole. First pitch is on the outside corner for strike one. Manny Parra, the starter tonight for the Bluefish, the left-hander on the mound right now, earned his first major league win in his first start of the 2008 season. Pitching for the Milwaukee Brewers, Cleary Jr. takes outside for ball one. That day, the Brewers defeated the Giants 5-4 at Miller Park in Milwaukee. 1-0. The fastball misses high, 2-1. We wanted to know which pitcher got the save for Manny Parra in his first big league win. We told you that he would go on a pitch for the Long Island Ducks, and the answer we'll give it to you after this 2-1 pitch. Parra deals. Cleary Jr. takes just low. Parra thought he had strike two. Instead, it's ball three. Cleary Jr. now in the driver's seat at 3-1. The answer, Eric Gagne, who relieved for Long Island earlier this year. He picked up the save his first of the season that year for the Milwaukee Brewers in 2008. Driving the air to right, hit pretty well off the bat of Cleary Jr. Back goes Dotel, and he'll make the grab for the first out. Cleary Jr. gave it a ride the opposite way to right field, but not deep enough. And with the wind blowing right to left, that did not help matters. So Cleary Jr. now 0-2 after yesterday going 0-3 with a run and a walk. And with one away, that is going to bring Jordan Pacheco up to the plate. Parra throwing the ball hard here in the early going. He has looked very strong for the Bluefish and now has a 4-run lead to work with. First pitch, Pacheco a ground ball foul to the Bluefish dugout on the third base side. Gagne in that 2008 season, his final big league season, would save 10 games and 50 appearances for the Brewers, went 4-3 with a 5.44 ERA that year. It's not the season that Gagne wanted, and certainly wasn't the season he wanted pitching for the Ducks earlier this year. Breaking ball on the outside corner for a strike two to Pacheco, who struck out swinging in the first. Pacheco has been hitting the ball well, though, of late, and he comes into tonight's game riding an on-base streak of 15 straight games. 0-2, swing and a miss, strike three. He chased down and away, back-to-back strikeouts. Two strikeouts for Pacheco, and now the fifth strikeout of the game for Manny Parra. Two away for the Ducks here in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll leave it up to the left fielder, Mark Krause. The Ducks did play last night a 3-hour, 15-minute game in York, and then had to take the about 4-plus-hour bus ride back here to Long Island, getting in at about 3:30 or so in the morning. Bluefish had the advantage of having the day game in Southern Maryland yesterday, so they got in yesterday evening to Long Island. Foul ball here along the first base side for Krause, who is one of two Ducks that have reached thus far, he and Lyons, as they have drawn walks. That has been it for Long Island's offense against the Bluefish southpaw. A 1 delivery. Fastball misses inside. Came close to catching Krause on the right hip. Even at 1-1, Krause had an RBI single last night, so that extended his on-base streak at the time to 18 straight games. Now is at 19 in a row, thanks to his walk earlier on. He's earned hits in 17 of those games. And a swing and a miss here on a fastball up and in for strike two, and Parra strike three away from another 1-2-3 inning. Bluefish lead it 4-0, out hitting the Ducks 8-0 into this point. Now the 1-2, breaking ball missing down and away. Good eye that time from Krause. Evens the count up at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Wine in the offering. Fastball misses outside from Parra. That'll work the count full at 3-2. If Krause reaches, Ruben Gotai will be next. Krause had a bit of a slow series against the Revolution. He still found ways to get on base in all three games, though. 3-2. Drive in the air to right. That's hit well. Back towards the foul pole. Will it stay fair? It does not. A foul ball down the right field line for Mark Krause, who nearly crushed one for his 15th home run of the season, but just hooked it to the right of the pole. And we'll do it once again at 3-2. That has got to be tough for the left fielder. Ducks have not really been squaring any baseballs well against Parra to this point. Another 3-2, and this is fisted out in the air towards second. Fielded there by the shortstop, Hernandez. He'll make the catch, and that'll retire the side. So Kraus nearly hits a massive home run down the right field line and then breaks his bat, pops out to short. Ducks go in order. We go to the fifth, 4-0 Bluefish.
Hey, fans. This is infielder Mark Kraus, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
PSEG Long Island is making things work for you with over 10 energy efficiency programs that can help you save on your monthly electric bill. From our free online energy analyzer and in-home energy assessments to rebates on energy-efficient air conditioning, even discounts on LED light bulbs. Helping you save on electricity is our job. What to do with your savings?
Flight 85 now boarding for the magic of Orlando.
Is entirely up to you. Visit PSEGLINY.com/save money. Just one more way PSEG Long Island is making things work for you.
Take your group out to the ball game this season and enjoy all the fun of Ducks baseball at discounted prices with the picnic area, luxury suites, the Smokin' Owls party deck, and so much more. Bringing your group to the game will be an unforgettable experience. The Ducks even offer opportunities to sing the national anthem, serve as the Ridgewood Savings Bank color guard, be the Nickelock Dream Team, put on a pregame performance, or shag fly balls during Ducks batting practice. To book your outing today, call 631-940-3825 and ask for the group sales department. Long Island Ducks Baseball. Good times every time.
Fifth inning coming up here at Bethpage Ballpark. 4-0 the Bluefish in front. And John Brownell's first pitch to Jose Cuevas in for a strike. Cuevas was the only Bluefish batter that did not come to the plate in the fourth inning. Nothing in one. Bridgeport scored 4 runs on 5 hits and 2 errors in the inning. And now the 0-1. The breaking ball misses low to even the count. Brownell looking to bounce back here in inning number 5. Ducks still looking for their first hit of the game. Nearly had it when Kraus drilled one down the right field line, but it went just foul. The 1-1 popped up in the air, foul, first base side. Jordan Pacheco chasing to the stands. This will be well back into the seats. Almost a terrific barehanded catch by a fan down in about section 214. Another count, 1-2. Cuevas over 2 thus far in the night. He has struck out looking and grounded into a 5-4-3 double play. Cuevas and Burrows, the only two Bluefish batters that have yet to reach base. He's fouled off. Also, Molina did not reach safely. He only reached on an error in the fourth inning. So of the 4 runs that scored, only 3 of them were earned because of that error by first baseman Jordan Pacheco, who moved over to first base and saw the ball squib between his legs. From the wine, here's the 1-2. Brownell deals. Cuevas drives one in the air to center. That's hit pretty well. Back goes Delta Cleary Jr. This one looks like it'll stay in the yard, though. And Cleary Jr. does make the catch in straightaway center for the first out of the inning. Well, let's start to take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard and get you caught up on what's going on around the Atlantic League and the Major League scoreboard. 2 games going on right now, as a couple teams have the day off. Somerset Patriots, who were just down at Sugarland, have the day off. As do the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. Those are the 2 teams who do have off. Skeeters are in Lancaster right now visiting the Barnstormers. Top of the 5th inning, the Skeeters have themselves a 3-1 lead. First pitch to Burrows, lifted foul down the left field line. And the count, nothing and 1. Brad Bergeson on the mound starting tonight for the Barnstormers. And for the Skeeters, Jake Hale is the starter. Sugarland getting all 3 of their RBIs off the bat of Kevin Ahrens. Barnstormers getting the run batted in from Cole Garner thus far. The 0-1 driven high in the air to right. Quentin Berry moving over to his left. Gets to the spot and makes the catch in right for the second out of the inning. Sean Burrows retired, 2 pop-ups off the bat of Brownell. And with 2 away, that will leave it up to Galvez, who has doubled twice thus far in the game. Other game going on right now is in New Britain, Connecticut, where the Revolution out to a great start. They lead the Bees 7-0, top half of the fourth inning. They have plated 6 runs in the fourth inning. New Britain started with Jonathan Pettibone, and now Brandon Shimo is on the mound. For York, Logan Williams in the starter tonight. Breaking balls on the outside corner for strike one. Jared Mitchell thus far is 3-for-3 with 2 RBIs and 2 runs scored. Carlos Trienfell has also driven in 2 runs to help lead the way for York. Breaking balls off the outside corner this time. And that will even things up. Add 1 ball and 1 strike. Brinell out of the windup. And the 1-1. High drive in the air to left center. That's hit well. Back goes Cleary Jr. to the warning track at the wall. And you can forget it. A solo home run to left center for Jonathan Galvez. It is his 11th home run of the season. His 3rd extra base hit in 3 at-bats. And Bridgeport leads it 5-0. So 2 deep drives off the bat of Bluefish hitters. Galvez this inning, Fields last inning, that went way out. 1 to center, 1 to left center. A solo home run for Galvez, his 45th one batted into the year. And he is 3-for-3 with 2 doubles, a homer, an RBI, and 2 runs scored. What a start for Galvez here tonight. So the lead now 5 for Bridgeport. First pitch here to Daniel Fields is swung on and missed as he chases a breaking ball low for strike 1. Fields, his last time up, crushed a 2-run home run to straightaway center right to the batter's eye. Grounded out to second his first time up, the 0-1. And that taken upstairs to even the count at 1-1. Mets lost in walk-off fashion 5-4 to the Colorado Rockies. A walk-off walk by Nolan Arenado. Greg Holland the win improved to 2-1. Hansel Robles the loser fell to 6-3. 1-1 misses the inside corner from Brownell for ball 2. Charlie Blackman with his 25th home run of the season for the Rockies, and also going deep was Mark Reynolds, his 23rd. Yoenis Cespedes hit his 11th for the Mets. Brownell misses low with a breaking ball and now behind in the count at 3-1. So a 2-out solo homer for Galvez. And now the 3-1 here to Fields. A swung and a line into right field. That's going to be another base hit for Bridgeport, their 10th of the game. Fields around first base. But we'll hold on there as Berry fires it back in at first. Almost was able to catch Fields behind on the throw. So back-to-back 2-out hits for the Bluefish. And up to the plate will step the catcher, Gustavo Molina. So Brownell is yet to retire the Bluefish in order, and they have smacked 10 hits against him thus far. Meanwhile, through 2 in Cleveland, the Indians have a 2-0 lead over the Yankees. Sonny Gray making his first start as the Yankees allowed 2 unearned runs thanks to a throwing error from Clint Frazier. Corey Kluber starting tonight for the Indians. Swung and foul tipped into the glove of Alex Berg for strike 1. So Sonny Gray's Yankees debut, and he has to face former Cy Young Award winner Corey Kluber. 0-1 here on Molina, who's 0-for-2. He lined out in that wacky play in the second and reached on an error. Here he skies one in the air to right. Quinton Berry is under it to make the catch, and Brownell works out of further trouble. But the Bluefish add another run on the solo homer from Jonathan Galvez. They get a run on 2 hits, no errors, and leave 1. Halfway through here at Bethpage Ballpark, 5-0, the Bluefish in front of the Ducks.
Hey fans, this is Yuri De La Rosa, left-hander pitcher, and you are listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Hey Ducks fans, the official hotel of the Long Island Ducks is the Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island. It's centrally located on the north shore of Long Island and offers a home away from home for both business and leisure guests. The Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island features an indoor pool, 24-hour business center, a fitness center, and complimentary Wi-Fi in all guest rooms. Enjoy the contemporary American cuisine at the Fountain Grill restaurant or grab a quick bite to eat at Cafe Pronto. And best of all, it's only minutes away from Bethpage Bowl. Park. The Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island, the official hotel of the Long Island Ducks. Call 631-231-1100 today. That's 631-231-1100.
Hey Ducks fans, stay up to date with Long Island's hometown team by visiting Quack of the Bat, the official blog of the Long Island Ducks. Quack of the Bat will bring Ducks fans beyond the headlines with in-depth feature articles, breaking news stories, game previews, post-game wrap-ups, and so much more. Interact with the team during the entire season through quotes directly from the players and coaches, as well as exclusive video clips and photos.
Check out the blog today at quackofthebat.wordpress.com. Quack of the Bat, the official blog of the Long Island Ducks. Ducks fans, chill out throughout the rest of the summer with a cold cup of Hampton Coffee Company Gourmet Iced Coffee. It's available at the concession stands at Bethpage Ballpark. Hampton Coffee is the preferred coffee of the Long Island Ducks. Visit HamptonCoffeeCompany.com or check out their cafes in the Hamptons. Bridgeport has hit two home runs. They have tagged John Brownell for 5 runs on 10 hits through 5 innings. They lead it 5-0. Meanwhile, the Ducks have drawn 2 walks, and that has been it over the first 4 innings against Manny Parra, who is back out for his 5th inning of work. And for Long Island, it'll be 5, 6, and 7 in the order. Gotay, Reyes, and Berg coming up to the plate. So the Ducks have a bunch of work to do if they want to fight back in this game. And obviously, every game is of tremendous importance right now for the Ducks, especially when they're facing the team that they're trying to catch in the division. First pitch, and Gotay takes a fastball strike over the inside corner, 0-1. Finishing up the out-of-town scoreboard, NFL's Hall of Fame game, the preseason game tonight at the NFL Hall of Fame, Pro Football Hall of Fame, I should say, in Canton, Ohio. It is the Cowboys hosting the Cardinals at 8 o'clock. Ground ball at the first baseline, foul. The count 0-2, and the United States Women's National Team takes on Japan out in Carson, California, in the Tournament of Champions that gets underway at 10 o'clock. 0-2 on Gotay, who wrapped into a 6-4-3 double play his first time up back in the second. And the 0-2 is grounded weakly here to the right side of the infield. Charging in on it is Tony Abreu. Shovels it to first in time for the out. And Gotay retired one away. Well, Manny Parra has now retired 5 in a row since the 2-out walk to Dan Lyons. And has retired 9 of 10 since allowing the leadoff walk to Mark Krause in the second. Long Island's offense, which was rolling along, had scored 6 runs or more in 5 straight games before being limited to just 2 on Tuesday and 3 yesterday. Has been held off the score sheet thus far tonight. First pitch is a breaking ball strike on the outside corner. 0-1 against Elmer Reyes. Thus far, Parra, 60 pitches in the game, 39 of them for strikes. The 0-1, swing and a miss, cut through the high fastball. And Parra gets ahead quickly, 0-2. Bluefish have had so much of their pitching staff get taken away by major league organizations. A plethora of signings throughout the course of the season, and yet they're still in first place in the division. Some of the names that they lost with the way that they were pitching this year, yet they still are holding on firmly to first place. 0-2. That misses off the outside corner. Their closer, David Carpenter, recently. Our reliever, Brian Moran. Starters Tyler Badamo, Chris Rierich, Corey Reardon, Jonathan Albaladejo, all getting their contracts purchased this year. And the only guy that remains from their opening rotation of the season is Rainey Lara, who will start tomorrow. But the others, Badamo, Rierich, Reardon, and Albaladejo, have all had their contracts purchased. And yet Bridgeport keeps on winning. 2-2. Ripped in the air down the left field line. There is a base hit for Elmer Reyes. It will head into the corner. Reyes around first. He'll dig for second. Here comes the throw. Not in time. And Reyes slides in safely with a one-out double. And that will end the no-hit bid for Manny Parra at 4 1/3 innings. So the Ducks have their first hit of the night as Reyes smokes his 15th double of the year into the left field corner. Runner at second, one away, and that'll bring up Alex Berg. Now, we had mentioned this a bit when the Ducks were in York and they fell behind in a big inning. You don't need to get all the runs right away, but you need to start getting the momentum onto your side. And imperative here for the Ducks to try and get at least 1 or 2 runs on the scoreboard and trim the deficit. Here's Alex Berg, first pitch. Berg drives one in the air to center. That's hit pretty well. Back goes Darby Myers, still back. Warning track at the wall. He looks up, and it is one hop and over the wall for a ground rule double. So Reyes will round third and come in to score. An RBI ground rule double for Alex Berg. And the Ducks have their first run of the night. They close to within 5-1. Berg
Kerr gave that one a ride, a straightaway center, just to the right of the batter's eye as we view it from behind home plate. For Alex Berg, his 25th run batted in of the season on his 14th double. And back-to-back doubles from Reyes and Berg have gotten the Ducks on the run column of the scoreboard. Now Giovanni Alfonso to the plate. First pitch from Parra, and Alfonso takes downstairs for ball one. Alfonso grounded to short his first time up. Berg now 1-for-2 in the game. And for Omar Reyes, his 22nd run of the year. From the stretch, here's the 1-0. Parra kicks and fires, and Alfonso pops it in the air, foul, first base side. This will go out of play. And leaving the count at 1-1. Alfonso did get a hit in yesterday's game, was 1-for-4, and has hit safely in 5 straight games coming in. Was 4-for-12 in the series at People's Bank Park. One-one delivery. Alfonso, a high fly ball in the air to center. Hit fairly well, but not deep enough. Myers back to retrieve it. He makes the catch. Berg will tag just to draw the throw from Myers. He makes a perfect one-hop throw to third base. So there is the second out of the inning as Alfonso now 0-for-2. And with two away, that'll leave it up to the shortstop and nine hitter, Dan Lyons. So here is Dan Lyons from the right side, who drew a walk his first time up, made it to third on an error, but was stranded there when Quentin Berry grounded out to first base. Ducks trying to get Berg home from second and make this a 3-run ball game. First pitch, Lyons takes a breaking ball at the knees for a called strike, and the count nothing and one. Lyons 1-for-3 at the plate in yesterday's game, scored a run and drew a walk. He has hit safely in 3 straight, and now with his walk has reach base safely in 8 in a row. 0-1. And the breaking ball misses down and away to even up the count at a ball and a strike. Ducks with their first 2 hits of the night. Back-to-back doubles from Reyes and Alex Berg have put the first run on the scoreboard for them. Berg leads at second with 2 down. And the 1-1 on the way from Parra. Lyons a swing and a miss. Chase the breaking ball down in the zone for strike 2. And now Parra strike 3 away from getting out of further trouble. Bottom of the 5th inning here of the series opener. Lyons was 5-for-10, by the way, in the series in York. He had 3 extra base hits, 5 RBIs, and 5 runs scored. Was the Ducks' best offensive player in the series. 1-2. And a good eye by Lyons there, not chasing out of the zone on another breaking ball from Parra downstairs. Berg scampers back to second in the count now, even at 2-2. Infield straightaway here for Dan Lyons. Parra gets the sign as he works out of the stretch. 2-2 pitch. Swinging a ground ball off of the leg of the pitcher. It caroms to first base. Burrows will have no play. And it'll be an infield single there for Dan Lyons. Berg will have to stop at third base. But that ball hitting the pitcher prevents the Ducks from getting a run. If it gets past and goes up the middle, Lyons has an RBI. Instead, it's an infield single. And now the Ducks have runners at the corners. Coming out of the dugout is going to be Luis Rodriguez. The manager for the Bluefish wants to check on him. Make sure that his starter is okay after taking that comebacker. Yeah. Seems to be all right, though. And he's going to stay in the game. Lyons with his first hit of the night, so he has now reached in 4 straight games.
It's back to the top of the order here along on the Ducks with right fielder, number 47, Quinton Berry, number 47.
So Lyons with this infield single. He is at first, Berg is at third, and Berry now to the plate. And now the Ducks with 3 hits. all here in this fifth inning. First pitch from Parra to Berry on the way, and Berry will take a breaking ball down and in for ball one. Parra was cruising along. Now his pitch count up to 74 on the night, 47 for strikes. And he's trying to get through five here to potentially qualify for the win if Bridgeport can hang on. Runners lead from the corners. Here's the 1-0. Parra kicks and comes home, and Berry swings and fouls this one off down the third baseline. Now leaving the count up at 1-1. Berry again missed the first two games of the series in York. He suffered a quad strain in the first game up in Bridgeport. He has hit safely in three in a row coming in, but is 0-2 thus far with a fly out to center and a ground out to first. 1-1 pitch. Berry a ground ball past the mound towards the middle. Hernandez can't get it. It's in a center field, a base hit. Berg will score. Lyons going for third, and he's in there safely with a head first slide. It's a two-out RBI single by Quentin Berry, and the Ducks have made it a three-run game at 5-2. A hot shot back towards the middle of the infield. Hernandez made a dive at it, but just could not come up with it. So Quentin Berry now has hit safely in four straight games. He picks up his third one batted in of the season. Lyons goes corner to corner. And now the Ducks with two on and two out. The tying run all of a sudden going to come to the plate in the form of Delta Cleary Jr. Good response by the Ducks here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. First pitch here is a breaking ball that misses low and outside of Cleary Jr., who has struck out and popped out to right and has two at-bats. He gave it a ride to right field this last time up, an inning ago leading off the frame, but could not get it over the head of Dotel. The best play 1-0 pitch. Cleary Jr., a foul ball over the screen back behind the plate. The Duck center fielder is the seventh man to bat in the inning. Coming off a 4-for-12 performance with three RBIs in York. Drew a walk, scored a run, and stole a base yesterday. And coming in, he has reached base safely in eight straight games. All these streaks, we talked about the Ducks coming alive offensively. 1-1 pitch. Cleary Jr. chases down in the zone, swinging through a breaking ball. Snap throw to first, but Berry is back there safely. Burroughs try to sell it. And the count 1-2. So Manny Parra, who was cruising through the first four innings, allowing just two walks in that stretch, has suffered a bit here in the fifth. He has allowed two runs on four hits in the inning. Now the Ducks with a tying run at the plate, and Cleary Jr. with a one ball, two strike count. Trying to keep this inning alive is the Ducks center fielder. 1-2 pitch from Manny Parra. Runner goes from first, and Cleary Jr. chases the breaking ball again for strike three as he swings through the pitch down in the zone. But the Ducks send seven men to the plate here in the fifth inning. They pick up two runs on four hits. No errors in the inning. They leave two on base, and after five innings of play, it is a 5-2 ball game in favor of Bridgeport.
Hey, fans. This is catcher Alex Berg, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Going way back is Joe Holden. And he is looking up, and that one is headed to field five at Robert Moses. The waves are gnarly, and the Ducks have tied it at one.
That was another home run for the Ducks. And Duck fans, what's more fun than a home run that helps the Ducks win a game? How about a homer that helps the community win? Chappie's Funeral Home and the Long Island Ducks have once again teamed up for the Chappie's Home Run Challenge. If the Ducks hit 100 homers this season, Chappie's Funeral Home will donate $5,000 to the Quacker Jack Foundation. So every time a Ducks hitter goes deep this season, watch for the Chappie's Challenge Home Run count on the scoreboard. And if we reach 100, we're all a winner. Chappie's Funeral Home, where caring for others is a family tradition.
Can't get enough of the Long Island Ducks? Well, now you can get even more inside info on your favorite hometown team through Facebook and Twitter. The Ducks are constantly updating fans through social media with scores, transactions, ballpark promotions, and much more. You can even win great prizes. All you'll need to do is make a free account on Facebook and Twitter, and then visit us at Facebook.com/LIDucks and Twitter.com/LIDucks. Think you're Long Island's biggest Ducks fan? Get connected now.
Ducks fans follow all season long as the Long Island Ducks try to meet the Chappies home run challenge. If the Ducks hit 100 home runs this season, then Chappies Funeral Homes will donate $5,000 to the Quacker Jack Foundation. Chappies Funeral Homes, where caring for others is our family tradition. So the Long Island Ducks trailing 5-2, but a good response. They get two runs on four hits after going hitless over the first four innings against Manny Parra. And they have cut the five-run deficit to three. And meanwhile, Kevin Bias has now gone to his bullpen. And he is going to call upon right-hander Tyler Levine, the East Meadow native, to come on and pitch for the Ducks in relief of John Brownell, who goes five innings against Bridgeport for the second straight outing. Well, this time the Bluefish not the better of him offensively compared to his last outing, in which Brownell allowed just one run on five hits over the five innings up in Bridgeport. Tonight, five runs, four of them earned on 10 hits against Brownell. And unless the Ducks can come back, he would suffer his third loss of the year. So Tyler Levine is on for the Ducks. We'll get you his numbers here shortly. Tony Abreu will lead things off, the switch hitting second baseman, who takes a fastball strike over the outside corner. Nothing at one. Abreu 1-for-2 on the night. He singled and scored two innings ago in the fourth, and grounded back to the mound in the second. 0-1. Line drive right center field. That is going to be a base hit for Abreu. Heads into the gap. Quentin Berry over to try and get to it. Abreu motoring to second. He's going to round second and head for third. And the throw in from Elmer Reyes is not in time. A leadoff triple off the bat of Tony Abreu. And not the way the Ducks wanted to start the sixth inning after getting two runs up on the scoreboard. So collectively as a team, the Bluefish have hit for the cycle tonight, as they now have a total of two doubles, two home runs, and the rest singles. That is a total of seven singles on the night. Six singles, along with a triple, two doubles, two homers. So Abreu is on with his third triple of the season. And now Wellington Dotel, who takes a first pitch strike. So Brownell's final line, he goes five innings, gives up 10 hits, five runs, four of them earned. Did not walk a batter and struck out two. And gave up the two home runs, the two-run homer for Daniel Fields, the solo homer for Jonathan Galvez. Dotel a little tapper foul, third base side. And now nothing in two on the right fielder, who is 1-for-2 with a single and a flyout. 76 pitches for Brownell, 54 of them for strikes. Infield is in all the way around, a cutoff the run at home plate. And Levine's 0-2 on the way to Dotel is a fastball that missed outside, 1-2. For Tyler Levine, this will be his 18th appearance of the year. He has three starts among those 18 appearances, and he's 2-0 with a 4.41 ERA. 1-2 pitch. Dotella drive in the air to left. That's hit well. Kraus going back to the warning track at the wall, and you can forget it. A two-run home run over the left field wall for Wellington Dotel. His first home run of the year, the third homer of the night for the Bluefish, and just like that, their five-run lead is back at 7-2. So a gut punch for the Ducks there. They have gotten it to within three, getting two big runs with the tying run at the plate. They cannot get anything further home, and now two batters into the sixth inning. The Bluefish have their five-run advantage back. So Dotel with his first home run, RBIs number three and four. And the Bridgeport Bluefish with three home runs tonight off of Ducks pitching. Not the start that Tyler Levine wanted here in the sixth inning. Darby Myers to the plate, and he takes low and outside for ball one. Coming into this appearance, Levine had thrown a total of 34 and two-thirds innings and had given up 41 hits, 19 runs, 17 of them earned. Popped up foul first base side. Jordan Pacheco ranging towards the stands will run out of room. It lands four rows back. 1-1 on Myers. 15 walks to 23 strikeouts for Levine coming in. And started against these Bluefish last Friday and allowed six runs on six hits in four and a third innings. Walked four, struck out three. Kevin Bias moved him into the starting rotation his last two outings after Dennis O'Grady moved from the rotation to the bullpen due to his innings limit. And Levine did not impress his last time out. Lost a 6-0 lead. Here he snares a comebacker off the bat of Myers and throws a little high to first, but Pacheco makes the play. And one away in this top of the sixth inning. And so Kevin Baez and the Ducks went back to Alfredo Simon as the starter, and Simon got off to a great start yesterday before crumbling in the fourth and the fifth. Allowed the 3-run home run to Alonzo Harris that gave York the win. So one down and the base is empty here in the sixth inning, and that will bring Luis Hernandez, the shortstop, to the plate, who is 1-for-3 on the night with a single. Fastball here by Levine hits the outside corner for strike one. Hernandez single to right in the first inning, reached on an error by Dan Lyons in the third, and struck out swinging in the fourth as part of a strike him out, throw him out, inning-ending double play. 0-1 is down in the dirt low. And that will even up the count at 1-1. Defense for the most part straight away. The third baseman Alfonso plays in tight with the hitter batting from the left side. Levine asks for time here and wants to go through the signs once again. Bluefish now out hitting the Ducks 12-4 in this one. 1-1. Line drive into the air to left field. Krause on the run. He's going to have to play it on a hop. It lands for a base hit. A one-out single to left for Luis Hernandez. Third hit of the inning off of Levine for Bridgeport.
Third baseman, number 11, Jose Cuevas, number 11.
It has been kind of eerie, too, when you think about the way this season has gone for the Ducks. The beginning of the season, really the majority of the first half, the offense wasn't there for Long Island. The pitching was very good for the Ducks throughout the course of the first half of the season, but was not being picked up by the offense. And now here, as the second half has kind of gotten into the swing of things, the offense has started to come alive for Long Island, but the pitching has not been there. They've been allowing runs at quite the clip of late. Swinging and a miss. Good fastball there from Levine. Now the count nothing and one on Cuevas, who is 0-for-3. Cuevas and Burrows, the 3-4 hitters, are combined 0-for-6 for the Bluefish in this game, but the rest of the lineup certainly making up for it, as six different Bluefish players have multi-hit games. One. Swing and a miss. Good fastball from Levine. Cuevas swings through it. Nothing and two. Ducks gave up 4 runs last night, but combined to give up 18 runs the 2 games prior. And up in Bridgeport, Long Island allowed a total of 27 runs in the 3 games. Gave up 8 twice, or excuse me, 17 runs in the 3 games. Gave up 8 in the first game and the last game, 1 in the middle game. 0-2, swing and a miss. Got Cuevas to chase down and away for strike 3. So Levine picks up his first strikeout. Second time Cuevas has struck out tonight. And 2 away, that is going to leave it up to Sean Burrows. Lots of high-scoring games between the Ducks and their opponents of late. And the pitching staff has not been able to quell their opponents at the way they were in the first half. And that has hurt, considering the offense has started to be a little bit better. So if Long Island cannot score, it'll be 3 straight games now that they're held to 3 runs or less. So here's Sean Burrows, who has popped out to the outfield all 3 times he's come up. Takes the first pitch, low and away, 4-1. Burrows popped out to right in the first inning and in the fifth inning, and then a fly out the opposite way to left in the fourth. A nice sliding catch made by Mark Krause towards the line. Again, the defense slightly shifted towards left center. 1-0. And Levine misses outside. Falls behind a good hitter in Burrows at 2-0. Bluefish have added 2 in the sixth inning. They now lead it 7-2 over the Ducks.
Come on. Go over here. Come on.
2-0 the count. Here's the pitch. Burrows swings away and fouls this one off to the third base side. That'll go back into the seats. And Levine gets strike 1 on the former Duck Burrows, who spent time in 2015 and 2016 with the Ducks. And then got traded back to the Bridgeport Bluefish.
We got more people. Don't take it. Come over here. Come on.
2-1 count. Levine fires. Burrow swings a ground ball back towards the middle. Dan Lyons will field behind second and throws on at first for the out. Might have hit the mound to slow it down a little. That'll end the inning. But the Bluefish get their 5-run lead back. They get 2 runs on 3 hits. No errors, and they leave 1. After 5.5 innings of play, it is 7-2 Bridgeport.
Hey, fans. This is pitcher Dennis O'Grady, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Oh, I love it. The color of my new Nicolat patio is so vibrant. It's unlike anything I've ever seen.
You're welcome. I'm just going to go finish that Nicolat walkway now.
Make your pavers vivid Nicolat pavers. The best looking, most vibrant pavers with the most 3-color blends in the industry. Featuring Nicolat's exclusive paver shield and color blending technology with color throughout and guaranteed not to fade. Live life in color with Nicolat. Visit Nicolat.com.
Have your birthday at the ballpark this season and celebrate with the flock. Kona Ice birthday party packages with the Long Island Ducks are now available. Each package includes 10 box seats, a commemorative birthday t-shirt and autographed baseball, a pizza and Kona Ice party in the Hebrew National picnic area, and so much more. Best of all, the birthday child will stand on the dugout while the entire crowd sings happy birthday. Reserve your party today by calling the group sales department at 631-940-3825. Kona Ice birthday parties with the Long Island Ducks, a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Bottom half of the sixth inning coming up with the Ducks trailing the Bluefish by a count of 7-2, being out hit 13-4 in this one. Manny Parra looks like he'll stay out there for his sixth inning of work tonight. And he's been pretty impressive here in his first start in a Bluefish uniform. Had the hiccup in the fifth, but otherwise has been pretty good. For the Ducks, they will send their 3, 4, and 5 hitters to the plate. And as we mentioned last inning, Ducks did well to get 2 runs on the scoreboard and chip into the deficit, but the key for the Ducks is twofold. They have to chip into the deficit, and then they have to keep the deficit where it is when they take the field. And Tyler Levine and the Ducks were not able to do that in the top half of the sixth inning. And now it's on the Ducks offense once again to try and cut into the gap. A missed opportunity certainly was the case for the Ducks yesterday. They left 10 on base, left the bases loaded in back-to-back innings. Now this pitch is taken high for ball one. In one situation, they were trailing by the count of 2-1. And in the other situation, they were leading 2-1, couldn't extend it. The other, they were leading 3-1 and couldn't extend it in the top of the fifth. This one fouled back, and that'll even the count at 1-1 on Pacheco, who has struck out swinging twice. And it was huge when the Ducks could not come up after they got the bases loaded with one out in the fifth inning. 3-1, could not add more. They had a runner thrown out at the plate on the RBI single by Gotay. And Alonzo Harris's 3-run home run proved to be the difference. Here a line drive, base hit in the left center field off the bat of Jordan Pacheco. Daniel Fields will cut it off and hold Pacheco at first. And there's the fifth hit of the night for Long Island, and Jordan Pacheco picks up another hit, and that will extend his on-base streak to 16 straight games. He and Mark Krause are two guys especially who are just finding ways to get on a nightly basis. Definitely a positive sign, especially for Pacheco, who got off to a very slow start here with the Ducks, but really has been coming on late. Quentin Berry, who has an RBI single tonight, another one of those guys who got off slow. And Berry and Pacheco are two in particular who have just been putting in all that extra work to try and correct themselves at the plate. First pitch here to Mark Krause. He'll take a breaking ball for a strike, nothing and one. You constantly see them out there on the field early before batting practice, taking extra swings in the cage on the field and off the field when they're not taking batting practice on the field. 0-1 from Parra to Krause. And Krause will swing and ground it hard but foul along the first base line. Oh, what a grab made there at first base. Not sure who that is coaching at first. I want to say Henderson Alvarez, who is tomorrow's starter, made the grab with the left hand, his non-pitching hand. So the count nothing and two here on Mark Krause, who has walked and popped to short. Nearly hit a home run his last time up, but it went just foul. 0-2. Krause pops it in the air, foul, third base side out of play. Do it again at nothing and two here on Krause. He has we mentioned with his walk earlier, now has reached base safely in 19 consecutive games, the longest on-base streak by a Duck. Here in 2017, that is, not the longest all time. The longest by a Duck for sure. 0-2 on the way once again. Krause a swing and a miss. Strike three out in front of the off-speed pitch. So Mark Krause strikes out for the first time tonight. That is the seventh strikeout for Manny Parra. One away here in the sixth inning. And that will bring up the designated hitter, Ruben Gotay. So here is Gotay to the plate, the switch hitter, batting from the right side against the lefty Parra. Pacheco leads him first on the first pitch. Gotay takes the fastball upstairs, 1-0. Gotay tonight has grounded out twice, once into a double play back in the second, and then he bounced to second base, leading off the fifth inning. Parra comes set. And there goes Pacheco, 1-0. On the outside corner for a strike, no throw down a second. And Pacheco in there safely with a stolen base. That will be his fourth steal of the year. Got such a good jump. No way Molina was going to throw down there to second. So the count 1-1 now on Gotay. Kicking the delivery. Swinging a little tapper out foul to the first base side of home plate. One ball, two strikes on Ruben Gotay. Game two of this series is going to be tomorrow night. Also a 6:35 start. It is also Salute to First Responders Night. And Ducks t-shirts are going to go out to the first 1,500 fans in attendance, courtesy of National Grid. That pitch misses outside, and that'll even up the count at 2-2. Power looks back to Pacheco at second base. 2-2 pitch. Gotay lays off the fastball and misses high and inside. That'll run the count full at 3-2. Elmer Reyes, who had the first hit of the night for Long Island, waiting in the on-deck circle. I have to think Parra's getting close to the end of his outing. He's up to 92 pitches now on the night. And after going hitless over the first four innings, Ducks have now strung together five hits over the last inning and a third against Parra. 3-2, and Gotay swings and rips a ground ball to third base. Right there is Jose Cuevas. He throws across the diamond in time. Third time that Gotay has grounded out tonight. Pacheco has to remain at second base. And with two down, that will leave it up to the second baseman, Elmer Reyes. Well, with Reyes coming to the plate and the fact that Parra gave up the double to Reyes the last time up, it looks like Luis Rodriguez is going to go to his bullpen here. He'll make his way out to the mound, and he's already looked down towards the bullpen out in left field. He's not taking the baseball yet from Parra. So everybody together have a discussion, and now he will signal to the bullpen. So Parra hands the baseball to Rodriguez. He'll make his way out towards the third base dugout in line for the win here in his first Bluefish appearance. Ducks trail 7-2. They've got a runner at second with two down here in the bottom half of the sixth inning.
Hey fans, this is pitching coach Billy Horn, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
PSEG Long Island is making things work for you with over 10 energy efficiency programs that can help you save on your monthly electric bill. From our free online energy analyzer and in-home energy assessments to rebates on energy-efficient air conditioning, even discounts on LED light bulbs. Helping you save on electricity is our job. What to do with your savings?
Flight 85, now boarding for the Magic of Orlando.
Is entirely up to you. Visit PSEGLINY.com/save money. Just one more way PSEG Long Island is making things work for you.
Take your group out to the ball game this season and enjoy all the fun of Ducks baseball at discounted prices with the picnic area, luxury suites, the Smokin' Owls party deck, and so much more. Bringing your group to the game will be an unforgettable experience. The Ducks even offer opportunities to sing the national anthem, serve as the Ridgewood Savings Bank color guard, be the Nickelock Dream Team, put on a pregame performance, or shag fly balls during Ducks batting practice. To book your outing today, call 631-940-3825 and ask for the group sales department. Long Island Ducks baseball. Good times every time.
Can't get enough of the Long Island Ducks? Well, now you can get even more inside info on your favorite hometown team through Facebook and Twitter. The Ducks are constantly updating fans through social media with scores, transactions, ballpark promotions, and much more. You can even win great prizes. All you'll need to do is make a free account on Facebook and Twitter, and then visit us at Facebook.com/LIDucks and Twitter.com/LIDucks. Think you're Long Island's biggest Ducks fan? Get connected now.
Manny Parra's first Bluefish appearance is done. His first start with Bridgeport. Last 5 2/3 innings, he exits with his team in front 7-2 here in the series opener. And Zach Groats, the right-hander, is going to come on a pitch for Bridgeport with Jordan Pacheco at second base and two men down. Ruben Gotay just grounded out to third after Krause had struck out following the single by Pacheco to begin the inning. And so Elmer Reyes will come to the plate for Long Island, and Reyes was the first Ducks batter to pick up a hit off of Parra as he smoked a double into the left field corner last inning. So knowing that, the right-hander Zach Groats comes out of the bullpen. Groats is going to face Reyes as the Ducks try an inch closer, trailing by 5. Second time they've trailed by 5 in this game. They went down 5-0 in the first half of the game, got 2 runs in the 5th, and gave the 2 runs back in the top of the 6th inning. First pitch here to Reyes. And Groats delivers a fastball strike over the outside corner, 0-1. So Parra as of now, 5 2/3 innings, 5 hits, 2 runs, 2 walks, 7 strikeouts. Still responsible for Pacheco at second. Here comes the 0-1. Breaking ball misses outside. And that evens the count at 1-1. Groats making his 48th appearance of the season. That leads this Bluefish team. He is 2-3, has a 3.99 ERA, and a couple of saves on the year. It's one game shy of the most in the Atlantic League. Brandon Fry of New Britain with 49 leads the league. Slider misses outside. And Reyes now in front of the count, 2-1.
Okay, guys.
For Groats, 47 1/3 innings, 52 hits, 28 runs, 21 of them earned, 21 walks to 58 strikeouts. Good strikeout-to-walk ratio for him. Pacheco leads the 2-1. Reyes a swing and a miss, cuts through the high fastball up and in. Now the count even at 2-2, and Groats a strike away from getting through the inning without giving up a run. From the stretch, here's the 2-2 delivery. Groats fires, and Reyes a swing and a miss, strike 3. So Zach Groats comes out of the bullpen, strikes out Elmer Reyes, and strands Jordan Pacheco at second. No runs, a hit, and one left for the Ducks. Through 6 on Long Island, 7-2, the Bluefish in front.
Hey fans, this is right-handed pitcher Tyler Levine, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
M&V Limousines is the official bus company of the Long Island Ducks. Family-owned and operated, they've been in the business for over 24 years. M&V Limousines offers coach buses with Wi-Fi and restrooms, party buses, exotic limousines, and also recently acquired Hampton Luxury Liner with regular service from New York City to the Hamptons. They also offer a variety of vineyard tour options. Whether you're looking for transportation for weddings, proms, corporate outings, or long-distance trips, they've got the right vehicle for you. Visit their showroom in Comac or check them out online at mvlimo.com. M&V Limousines and Hampton Luxury Liner, the official bus company of the Long Island Ducks.
Family fun every time.
Beautiful evening for baseball.
Big action every time.
He reaches up. It's gone!
Great
value every time.
And the Ducks have won it 7-1.
The Ducks schedule is loaded with new promotions this season. And with an average ticket price of just $10 and free parking, there is no better value on Long Island. For game times and tickets, visit liducks.com. Long Island Ducks Baseball. Good times every time.
Oh, I love it. The color of my new Nicolat patio is so vibrant. It's unlike anything I've ever seen.
You're welcome. I'm just going to go finish that Nicolat walkway now.
Make your pavers vivid Nicolat pavers. The best looking, most vibrant pavers with the most three color blends in the industry. Featuring Nicolat's exclusive paver shield and color blending technology with color throughout and guaranteed not to fade. Live life in color with Nicolat. Visit Nicolat.com.
Ducks fans, don't forget to stop by the Waddle Lynch Shop on your next visit to Bethpage Ballpark, where exclusive hard-to-find Ducks memorabilia is now on sale. Proceeds benefit the Quacker Jack Foundation, charitable arm of the Long Island Ducks. And brand new at the Waddle Lynch Shop, 2017 Long Island Ducks team card sets have arrived. Beautiful card set featuring 30 cards of your favorite Ducks players, along with the coaching staff, and of course Quacker Jack, could not forget him. Beautiful color glossy photo on the front of the card and information along with a biography and some statistics on the back of the card. Just a terrific collector's item for any Ducks fan. And they are available now at the Waddle Lynch Shop. You can get them by visiting the store, which is open during every Ducks game, and on non-game days from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday to Friday. And you can also get them by going online at liducks.com and clicking on the merchandise icon. Jonathan Galvez, who has had a terrific start to his night, will come to the plate, and that will begin the top of the seventh. Patrick Kreider, meanwhile, the left-hander, has come out of the bullpen for the Ducks, and the first pitch to Galvez is on the outside corner for strike one. Tyler Levine pitches one inning in the sixth and was roughed up for two runs on three hits, including the two-run home run from Wellington Dotel. Did not walk a batter and struck out one. Here's the 0-1. Fastball hits the outside corner, another strike, and Kreider quickly ahead at nothing and two. Galvez has two doubles, a homer. He has driven in a run and scored twice. 0-2. Breaking ball on the inside corner, strike three call. Galvez did not agree. He is shaking his head vehemently at home plate. Kreider gets a strikeout on three pitches and one away here in the seventh inning. For Patrick Kreider, this is his 42nd appearance of the year. That is the most on this Ducks team. And comes in with an 0-5 record and a 3.27 ERA. 33 innings, has allowed 28 hits, 14 runs, 12 of them earned, has walked 19 and struck out 38. Face the left fielder Daniel Fields with one down and the bases empty. And the first pitch is a breaking ball strike over the outside corner. Four straight strikes from Kreider, all looking. Kreider last pitched on Tuesday night during the Ducks' 11-2 loss to New York and had arguably his worst outing of the year. The 0-1 slider, outside corner, a strike, nothing in two. Faced six batters, did not report an out, and allowed three runs, two of them earned on four hits and a walk, an error thrown in there as well. Now is 0-2 to Fields. Kreider fires and Fields takes the fastball up and away. That'll run the count to 1-2. Fields tonight is 2-for-3 with a two-run home run, which came back in the fourth to straightaway center. Elmer Reyes made a nice play on his grounder in the second, otherwise he'd have three hits on the night. 1-2. And Kreider tried to get him to chase the breaking ball again. He would not. So now the count even. Kreider gets the sign and comes set. Here is the 2-2 delivery. Driving the air to left by Fields. That's hit pretty well. Back goes Krause at the track, at the wall, and you can forget it. Daniel Fields goes the opposite way and left for a solo home run. His second long ball of the night. The fourth home run in the game for Bridgeport, and they lead it 8-2. Boy, Bridgeport is absolutely pounding the baseball tonight as they have put up 8 runs off of Ducks pitching and have hit 4 home runs. Fields with his second of the night, his 12th of the season. And Kreider allows a run for the second straight outing. So with one away and now a run in, here is Gustavo Molina to the plate. Molina takes a breaking ball that just missed the outside corner from Kreider. Kreider got ahead, nothing in two. He had thrown 5 straight strikes, but missed with 2 in a row, trying to get him to chase, and then Fields hits the home run. And this Bridgeport team has shown good patience at the plate, waiting for their pitch to hit. 1-0, and Kreider misses outside again, and it's 2-0. Boy, Kreider went from just dealing strike after strike now to missing with a couple, giving up a home run, and now missing with 2 more. Quite the turnaround. Left-hander gets the sign. Here is the 2-0 to Molina. And the catcher pops it in the air, foul first base side. Long run for Pacheco to the stands. And on the warning track, he makes it over the shoulder grab. Nice play by Jordan Pacheco in foul ground on the right side of the infield. Make that over the shoulder catch for the second out of the inning. The Ducks have made some pretty nice defensive plays tonight. They have also made 3 errors, though. Only one of which really has come back to cost them in the game, although one allowed a run to score, though that run was unearned anyway. So a 2 away, that'll bring up Tony Abreu. By the way, Molina now 0-for-4 with a run scored after he did reach and score on the errors in the fourth. Abreu, meanwhile, 2-for-3, and takes the first pitch fastball high and outside, 1-0. Abreu grounded out to the mound in the second, then singled and scored in the fourth, tripled and scored in the sixth. This Bluefish offense, just keeps on hitting the baseball. 1-0. Fouled back over the screen. And off to our right into the seating bowl. So that'll even up the count at 1-1. Rayu's triple was his third of the year. He has now scored 37 runs on the season. 1-1 from Kreider. Driving the air to right, Quentin Berry back into his right, and on the run, he'll make the grab for the final out of the top of the seventh inning. So the Bluefish get another run on another hit. Daniel Field's second home run of the night. And after 6.5 time to stretch, Bluefish leading the Ducks 8-2.
Hey fans, this is pitcher Rob Rogers, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Long Island's Ford Giant is celebrating its 60th year anniversary. Stop by Sayville Ford to check out their state-of-the-art showroom featuring enclosed service drives, luxurious customer lounge, and a larger selection to choose from. Get giant savings on hundreds of new and used vehicles in stock. Sayville Ford's 60th anniversary celebration is going on now. Visit SaylvilleFord.com or download the Sayville Ford app today to learn more about Sayville Ford's 60th anniversary savings. Call 631-589-4800 today.
Baseball fans, the Long Island Ducks mobile app has officially arrived. Powered by Clear Vision Apps, it's your one-stop shop for all things Ducks baseball. Buy tickets straight from your mobile device. Receive game status updates with push notifications. Check out up-to-the-minute news and scores and interact with the Ducks on social media. Best of all, it's free. Download the Ducks mobile app today by visiting the App Store on your Apple-powered device or Google Play on your Android-powered device. The Long Island Ducks mobile app, with you wherever you flock to.
Michael Pollock here with you as we go to the bottom half of the seventh inning. Another tough night for the Ducks as the pitching staff has allowed 8 runs on 14 hits, including 4 home runs, 2 from Daniel Fields, 1 from Jonathan Galvez, and 1 from Wellington Dotel. And Bridgeport leads it 8-2 over Long Island. Now the Ducks running out of opportunities to try and fight back here in this series opener. A loss here would drop Long Island to 3.5 games back in the Liberty Division standings behind Bridgeport. That would also be the Ducks' third consecutive defeat, would drop them to 4 games under .500. But the Ducks still have 3 turns at home plate. And Zach Rhodes, who got the final out of the Bottom of the sixth, striking out Elmer Reyes, is going to stay in. And he will face Alex Berg, Giovanni Alfonso, and Dan Lyons, the bottom three in the Ducks' order. First pitch to Berg, swing and a miss, out in front of the fastball from the right-hander. And the count nothing and one. Berg one for two on the night. Had an RBI ground rule double in the fifth and then scored on Quentin Berry's RBI single. Struck out swinging back in the third. Here's the 0-1. Fouled off first base side. That is out of play. And runs the count nothing and two. Berg was 3-for-9 in the series in New York. He had a double and two runs scored, but did not play in yesterday's game. And struggled this year against the Bluefish. Just 6-for-38 coming in.
Can't see. Sorry, my man.
You sit down already?
You guys are so quiet, I forgot you were back there.
So it'll be an 0-2 on the way. Rhodes kicks and fires to the plate. Berg takes a fastball on the outside corner. Strike three call. Rhodes with a second strikeout and as many hitters faced. One away in the seventh. The second time Berg has struck out tonight. Nine strikeouts now for Bluefish pitching. So on the one away here is Giovanni Alfonso to the plate. As he will come up to bat for the second time tonight. Alfonso, Gotai, and Cleary Jr., the only three Ducks who have not reached base safely in this game. And the first pitch fastball misses high and inside, 1-0. Alfonso is 0-for-2. He is grounded out to short and popped out to center. Now 10 of 35 against the Bluefish this year. Just under the 300 mark. Swings through a fastball, and that'll even the count at 1-1. Alfonso was 4-for-12 in New York, had a double and two RBIs, scored three times. 1-for-4 in yesterday's game. 1-1. Takes the breaking ball down and away. Would not bite after it. And it's 2-1. Henderson Alvarez going to start for the Ducks tomorrow. He has looked impressive over his first three starts. 2-1. Lays off high fastball. 3-1. And Rainey Lara, who the Ducks roughed up on Sunday in Bridgeport, will start for the Bluefish tomorrow night. Here's the 3-1. Good hitters count. Alfonso swings through a high fastball for strike two. Not a middle in fastball. Good pitch to hit. Just missed it. And Groats has worked the count full. Payoff pitch on the way from the right-hander. And Alfonso swings through a fastball over the outside corner. Strike three. They get three batters and three strikeouts for Gross. And now 10 strikeouts for the Ducks offense tonight. 2-1, that'll leave it up to the shortstop, Dan Lyons.
Ducks shortstop, number 12, and Lyons, number 12.
Dan Lyons has once again had a positive night for the Ducks. A walk and a single in his two trips to the plate, but he has been stranded at third base both times he's come up. So here is Groats from the right side against Lyons from the right side. First pitch, Lyons takes the fastball over the outside part of the plate, but it missed for ball one. Lyons came in hitting 289 against the Bluefish. He is now 12-for-39 on the year against Bridgeport. Four doubles, two RBIs, seven runs. He's got a homer as well. Chases a slider outside, and that'll even up the count. What a series for Lyons in York, 5-for-10 at the plate. With three extra base hits, two doubles, a home run, five RBIs, and five runs. Also drew a walk and lifted a sac fly to the outfield. 1-1, swings through a fastball and misses. And now Zach Groats a strikeout away from striking out the side here in the seventh inning. Two down, the bases empty, the Ducks trailing by six. And the 1-2, swinging a fly ball in the air to center. Backing up a couple steps, Darby Myers. He is there to make the catch. Zach Groats retires the side in order in the seventh inning. 8-2 Bridgeport after seven. We head to the eighth here at Bethpage Ballpark.
Hey fans, this is pitcher Patrick Kreider.
and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
PSEG Long Island is making things work for you with over 10 energy efficiency programs that can help you save on your monthly electric bill. From our free online energy analyzer and in-home energy assessments to rebates on energy-efficient air conditioning, even discounts on LED light bulbs. Helping you save on electricity is our job. What to do with your savings?
Flight 85, now boarding for the magic of Orlando.
Is entirely up to you. Visit PSEGLINY.com/save money. Just one more way PSEG Long Island is making things work for you.
Take your group out to the ballgame this season and enjoy all the fun of Ducks baseball at discounted prices with the picnic area, luxury suites, the Smokin' Owls party deck, and so much more. Bringing your group to the game will be an unforgettable experience. The Ducks even offer opportunities to sing the national anthem, serve as the Ridgewood Savings Bank color guard, be the Nickelock Dream Team, put on a pregame performance, or shag fly balls during Ducks batting practice. To book your outing today, call 631-940-3825 and ask for the group sales department. Long Island Ducks Baseball. Good times every time.
We are back here as we move to the top half of the eighth inning. And the Long Island Ducks trailing the Bridgeport Bluefish by a count of 8-2. Zach Treese is on to pitch for the Ducks. He is Long Island's third reliever of the night. Takes over for Patrick Kreider. And the first pitch is in for a strike, nothing and one. So Kreider goes one inning in the seventh, allows a run on a hit, the solo home run. That was hit by Daniel Fields. Did not walk a batter and struck out one. The 0-1 is a little weak tapper to the third baseline, foul. And Wellington Dotel, who is 2-for-3, behind in the count, and nothing in two. Patrice making his first appearance of this series. And he struggled a little bit in York. Last pitched in that game that Kreider struggled as well. Swing and a miss. Good slider there for Treese, and he gets a strikeout. So a good start for Treese here in the eighth inning. Fifth strikeout for Ducks pitching, and one away here in the eighth. In that game, Treese allowed two runs on three hits and a walk, struck out two in an inning and a third. And in that seventh inning in which York scored five runs on Tuesday night, Treese, who had thrown an inning in the sixth, stayed in for the seventh, allowed hits to two of the first three hitters. And then Kreider took over, and that's when the floodgates opened. Back to the top of the order we go. Darby Myers to the plate. He takes a breaking ball outside. And the count goes to 1-0. Myers on the night, 2-for-4, a pair of singles. He has driven in a run. His 37th run batted in of the season. That was on a base hit to left in the fourth, which scored Tony Abreu. 1-0. Ripped towards short, and Lyons makes the catch. They say it was caught in the air. Fred DeJesus, the third base umpire, made the call. So Myers hits it hard, but right at short. And Zach Treese on a total of five pitches has recorded two outs here in the eighth. Ducks have still yet to retire the Bluefish in order at any point in this game. The closest they got was in the first inning when Brownell allowed just a single to Luis Hernandez, the second batter of the inning. Let's see if the Ducks can get a 1-2-3 inning here in the eighth. Hernandez, the switch hitting shortstop, two hits and four at-bats tonight. Takes a fastball strike over the outside corner from Treese, nothing and one. Treese comes in 6-1 with a 4.74 ERA on the year, 39 games, has allowed 41 hits in 38 innings. 23 runs, 20 of them earned, 22 walks to 39 strikeouts. And here a chopper to the left side. Alfonso can't get it. Lyons does the throw to first. He got him. Nice play by Dan Lyons on the high chopper. He makes a long, accurate throw to retire the speedy Hernandez. So the Ducks retire the side in order for the first time tonight. It's another PSEG Long Island energy efficient inning. With energy efficiency programs from PSEG Long Island, saving on your electric bill is also as easy as 1, 2, 3. Visit PSEGLiny.com/save money. Just one more way PSEG Long Island is making things work for you. To the bottom of the eighth we go. Ducks trail at 8-2.
Hey fans, this is infielder Giovanni Alfonso, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
PSEG Long Island is making things work for you with over 10 energy efficiency programs that can help you save on your monthly electric bill. From our free online energy analyzer and in-home energy assessments to rebates on energy-efficient air conditioning, even discounts on LED light bulbs. Helping you save on electricity is our job. What to do with your savings?
Flight 85, now boarding for the Magic of Orlando.
Is entirely up to you. Visit PSEGLiny.com/save money. Just one more way PSEG Long Island is making things work for you.
Hey, Ducks fans, the official hotel of the Long Island Ducks is the Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island. It's centrally located on the north shore of Long Island and offers a home away from home for both business and leisure guests. The Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island features an indoor pool, 24-hour business center, a fitness center, and complimentary Wi-Fi in all guest rooms. Enjoy the contemporary American cuisine at the Fountain Grill restaurant or grab a quick bite to eat at Cafe Prato. And best of all, it's only minutes away from Bethpage Ball. Park. The Radisson Hotel Hop Hog Long Island, the official hotel of the Long Island Ducks. Call 631-231-1100 today. That's 631-231-1100.
Bethpage Ballpark is a great place to watch a ball game, so why not do so from some of the best seats in the house? The Ducks are proud to present the brand new Long Island Ducks Beer Garden. Open for all fans on nights when the Smokin' Owl's party deck has not been reserved. The Beer Garden will feature a variety of frosty draft and bottled brews, as well as several food choices. The area has been decked out with bar rail seating and Ducks-branded furniture to provide a comfortable atmosphere for everyone. Be sure to stop by and check out the brand new Long Island Ducks Beer Garden on your next visit to the ballpark.
Hey fans, this is pitcher Zach Treese, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Ducks fans, do you want frequent updates on team transactions, scores, store specials, and the status of upcoming games? Well, then follow the Long Island Ducks on Twitter at twitter.com/LIDucks. With Twitter, the faithful flock will be able to follow their Ducks and find out more information regarding nightly promotions, player signings, league activities, and so much more. The Ducks are tweeting right now, and you can follow along at twitter.com/LIDucks. Left-hander Wander Perez is the new pitcher for the Bridgeport Bluefish. He takes over after Zach Groats retires all four hitters he faces between the sixth and the seventh innings and striking out three of them. First pitch here to Quentin Berry. And he takes a fastball a little bit low from Perez. And the count 1-0. Berry on the night is 1-for-3 for Long Island. Had an RBI infield single back in the fifth inning. Actually trickled off the shortstop Hernandez's glove and went into center field. There's a breaking ball strike on the outside corner, 1-1. Picked up his third RBI of the season, also has grounded out to first and popped out to center. One delivery, kicks and fires, and Berry swings and fouls it straight back. Got jammed on the pitch and fought it off back to the screen, 1-2. For Wander Perez, this will be his fourth appearance with Bridgeport. 0-1 thus far with a 2.46 ERA. It's the sign and comes set. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Kicks and deals, and Berry is swinging a miss. Strike three as he chases down and away. Ducks have had a tough time squaring up the baseball tonight, and they have now struck out a total of 11 times against Bluefish pitching, many of those expanding the zone. Out of those 11 strikeouts, just two of them have been looking. Reyes in the second inning and Berg in the seventh. So one away, and that'll bring up Delta Cleary Jr. Perez has thrown 3 2/3 innings thus far, 3 hits, a run, 1 walk, and 5 strikeouts. First pitch to Cleary Jr., and he takes a breaking ball strike over the outside corner. He came to the plate with runners at first and third and 2 down in the fifth, representing the tying run after the Ducks had gotten it to 5-2, but he chased out of the zone a couple of times and struck out swinging. And the Bluefish have scored 3 runs since that point and lead it by 6. Takes downstairs here. And that'll even up the count at 1-1. Cleary Jr., 0-3 on the night with 2 strikeouts and a flyout. He is in danger of seeing an 8-game on base streak come to an end if he cannot get on here tonight. 1-1, ripped on the ground towards the middle, but the shortstop Hernandez is there. And he throws on the first in time for out number 2 here in the 8th. And this is obviously no excuse. Everybody has to go through the travel, and even though the Ducks had to travel later, they did not have to travel as far as Southern Maryland, as Bridgeport did, coming from Southern Maryland, whereas Long Island came from York. York is about an hour, hour and a half closer than Southern Maryland is. But regardless of that, Ducks obviously did not get in until late, whereas Bridgeport was in the evening. First pitch here to Jordan Pacheco. And that fastball's on the inside corner, strike one. The Ducks will tell you that that's obviously no excuse, even though they got in late. Team did not have to arrive early today for any particular reason. And so they did get rest during the course of the day. But Manny Parra was strong on the mound, and the Ducks' offense has not been able to do too much tonight. Meanwhile, Bridgeport has hit 4 home runs and has pounded out 14 hits against John Brownell and the rest of the Ducks' relief corps. Pitch was taken inside, 1-1 on Pacheco, who was 1-3 on the night, singled and stole a base in the 6th inning. Before that, 2 strikeouts, both swinging. Here's the 1-1. Perez kicks and fires home. Pacheco takes a breaking ball that's on the outside corner at the knees for strike 2. So Wander Perez looking to retire the Ducks in order in the 8th. Last eight Ducks batters to come to the plate since the leadoff single by Pacheco in the 6th have been retired. And the 1-2 is crushed in the air to left center, hit pretty well. On the run is the left fielder Fields. He won't get it. It'll land in the gap and go to the wall. Pacheco will go to second, and he's there safely with a 2-out double. Second hit of the night for Jordan Pacheco. He picks up his 13th double of the season. He has certainly been hitting doubles at quite the rate of late. So Pacheco on with 2 down, and that'll bring up Mark Krause with a runner on base for Long Island. So here is Krause for the Ducks. For Pacheco, that is his 5th double in the last 7 games that he has played. Doubles in all 3 games against the Bluefish up in Bridgeport last weekend. First pitch on the way here to Mark Krause from Perez. Lefty-lefty matchup, and the breaking ball misses outside, 1-0. Krause tonight is 0-2 with a walk. He drew that walk his first time up in the 2nd inning, and since then has popped to short and struck out swinging. The pop-up coming one pitch after he nearly crushed a home run down the right field line. 1-0. High drive in the air to right center. That's hit well. Back goes Myers at the warning track, and he'll make the catch. Krause gave it a ride and sounded good off the bat, but he just missed hitting it out. Hit it to the deepest part of the park, and the side retired in the 8th. No runs, 1 hit, 1 left at 2nd. To the 9th we go, 8-2 Bridgeport.
Hey, fan, this is a pitcher, Amali Diaz, and you're listening to the Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Going way back is Joe Holden, and he is looking up, and that one is headed to field 5 at Robert Moses. The waves are gnarly, and the Ducks have tied it at 1.
That was another home run for the Ducks. And Duck fans, what's more fun than a home run that helps the Ducks win a game? How about a homer that helps the community win? Chappie's Funeral Home and the Long Island Ducks have once again teamed up for the Chappie's Home Run Challenge. If the Ducks hit 100 homers this season, Chappie's Funeral Home will donate $5,000 to the Quacker Jack Foundation. So every time a Ducks hitter goes deep this season, watch for the Chappie's Challenge Home Run count on the scoreboard. And if we reach 100, we're all a winner. Chappie's Funeral Home, where caring for others is a family tradition.
Can't get enough of the Long Island Ducks? Well, now you can get even more inside info on your favorite hometown team through Facebook and Twitter. The Ducks are constantly updating fans through social media with scores, transactions, ballpark promotions, and much more. You can even win great prizes. All you'll need to do is make a free account on Facebook and Twitter, and then visit us at Facebook.com/LIDucks and Twitter.com/LIDucks. Think you're Long Island's biggest Ducks fan? Get connected now.
Zach Treese is going to stay in for a second inning of relief after retiring the side in order. And the top half of inning number 8. And he'll try and record 3 outs here in the 9th and give the offense a chance to rally back in the bottom of the 9th inning. So the Ducks trailing 8-2 here in the opening game of this series, in danger of losing their third straight overall and dropping their second in a row to the Bluefish. After falling on Sunday at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, a killer of a game for the Ducks when they had a 7-0 lead going into the bottom of the 8th. It was 7-2 with 2 down and the bases empty. But then the Bluefish rallied, scored 6 runs with 2 outs, and won it 8-7. Good slider for strike 1 over the outside corner. And the count 0-1 on Jose Cuevas, who tonight has gone 0-4. He and Burrows, along with Gustavo Molina, the 3 Bluefish batters that have yet to reach base safely in this game. Everybody else for Bridgeport has multiple hits, and this screamer goes foul to the first base side into the seats, and the count 0-2. It'll be a tough decision on the player of the game. I've got 2 guys in my mind right now if everything held up. And if you had to pick between the 2, I don't know how you'd do it. We'll see. Another 0-2 coming here from Zach Treese to Jose Cuevas. Kicking the pitch, swing and a miss, strike 3 as Cuevas waves at the slider. Third time he has struck out tonight, he's got the hat trick. Second strikeout for Zach Treese. And the 6th strikeout for Ducks pitching.
First baseman number 15, Sean Burrows, number 15.
So with one away here is Sean Burrows, who, like Cuevas, has yet to get on base, 0-4 to this point. 3 flyouts and a ground out. Want to send our congratulations to Sean, who a little less than a month ago got to celebrate the birth of his first child, a baby boy born out in his home of California. Pitch misses low and inside for ball 1. And I kid you not, the child's name is Knox, and K-N-O-X, but Sean Burrows, a guy who obviously hits the ball very well. He's hitting .335 right now. And he likes to call those base hits knocks. That's what he always calls them. Pitch misses outside for ball 2. And when he was a member of the Ducks, always around the batting cage, whenever somebody would hit the baseball, when he would hit the baseball, whether or not he thought it would have been a base hit if it was a game situation, he'd always go, "That's a knock. That's a knock." So that name kind of sticks. Well, there's a knock for Burrows as he picks up a base hit into the right center field gap. Larry Jr., a long way to go, get it in the gap. Burrows is going to head to second, and he is going to stop there with a 1-out double. So there's the first hit given up by Zach Treese. Burrows has his first hit of the night and the 15th hit for Bridgeport in this game. So again, congratulations to Sean and his family on the birth of his son, Knox. And we'll see if he grows up to be a future major leaguer just like his daddy was. 1 out, and here is Jonathan Galvez, who is one of the 2 guys I've been thinking about for player of the game with what he has done tonight for Bridgeport. He did strike out looking his last time up back in the 7th inning. First pitch on the way. takes a breaking ball on the inside corner for strike one. Galvez a ground rule double in the second inning, a double and a run in the fourth, and a solo home run to straightaway center in the fifth. Now the 0-1, swing and a miss as he chases another good slider from Treese down and away. Treese jumps ahead in the count, nothing in two. Now his home run was hit just to the left of the batter's eye, off of the back wall of advertising out in left center field. So he's got three hits, as does the man waiting on deck. Breaking ball on the inside corner, strike three called. Galvez goes down looking. Second strike out of the inning for Zach Treese. And his third of the night, two away, and that'll leave it up to Daniel Fields. Well, Fields is certainly the other candidate right now. He's got three hits, including a pair of home runs, a two-run blast to center in the fourth, and a solo blast to left in the seventh. He has driven in three and scored twice. And I have to say, if I had to choose right now, he would be the lead candidate. Still a lot of game to go here in the top of the ninth inning. First pitch from Treese on the way, and Fields will swing and hit a weak tapper foul to the first base side, nothing and one. Fields was robbed of a base hit two his first time up in the second inning, hit one towards the hole on the right side, and Elmer Reyes made a nice grab. Otherwise, he might have a four-hit night. Now the Ducks defense, Pacheco playing right along the line at first, now takes a couple steps to his right off of the line, but Pacheco over into the hole on the right side. 0-1. Fields takes the breaking ball down and in. That'll leave it up the count at 1-1. Treese trying to make it back-to-back scoreless innings in the eighth and the ninth. Bridgeport had scored in every inning from the fourth through the seventh. Four in the fourth, one in the fifth, two in the sixth, and one in the seventh. After being held off the scoreboard for the first three innings. 1-1. Swing and a miss. Fields chased the breaking ball down in the zone for strike two. And Treese a strike three away from striking out the side here in the inning. Sean Burroughs leads from second with two down. He doubled to right center with one away in the inning. Treese gets the sign and comes set. And the 1-2 pitch, slider just off the outside corner. Trying to paint the black there to get Fields looking for the final out, but just broke around the plate. That'll even things up at 2-2. Treese bent over as he looks in for the sign and once again is ready to go. 2-2 pitch. Fields a half swing on a fastball down and in. They appeal. And Fred DeJesus says he went around for strike three. So Fields goes down swinging. Zach Treese strikes out the side here in the ninth inning. And he has struck out four over two scoreless innings. To the bottom of the ninth we go. Ducks need a rally. They trail 8-2.
Hey fans, this is pitcher David Artsma, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Oh, I love it. The color of my new Nicolat patio is so vibrant. It's unlike anything I've ever seen.
You're welcome. I'm just going to go finish that Nicolat walkway now.
Make your pavers vivid Nicolat pavers. The best looking, most vibrant pavers with the most three color blends in the industry. Featuring Nicolat's exclusive paver shield and color blending technology with color throughout and guaranteed not to fade. Live life in color with Nicolat. Visit Nicolat.com.
Hey Ducks fans, stay up to date with Long Island's hometown team by visiting Quack of the Bat, the official blog of the Long Island Ducks. Quack of the Bat will bring Ducks fans beyond the headlines with in-depth feature articles, breaking news stories, game previews, post-game wrap-ups, and so much more. Interact with the team during the entire season through quotes directly from the players and coaches, as well as exclusive video clips and photos. Check out the blog today at quackofthebat.wordpress.com. Quack of the Bat, the official blog of the Long Island Ducks. Bottom half of the ninth inning, Long Island Ducks trailing the Bridgeport Bluefish 8-2 here in the series opener. And for Bridgeport, Vinny Pestano is going to come out of the bullpen, and the right-hander will try and close this one out for Bridgeport to give them the victory here in the series opener and even up the Ferry Cup series here in 2017 at 7 wins apiece. And would move the Ducks to 3.5 games in back in the Liberty Division standings, basically requiring Long Island to come away with victories in the final three games of this series to just stay similar to where they are right now, which is 2.5 games in back. If the Ducks split this series, they'll still be 2.5 back, and only three games would remain between these two teams throughout the rest of the year. Obviously, many things can happen, but time winding down here for the Ducks. This is game number 96 on the season for Long Island out of 140, which means there are 44 to go after tonight. And that may seem like a lot, but it really is not, especially when you consider that of those, just six now will be against Bridgeport. And they still have a total of 7 to go, I believe, against the Somerset Patriots. So, it will be Ruben Gotai coming up to the plate. Now that I think about it, only four, I think, are left against Somerset, if I'm not mistaken. Trying to go back through and remember when those two teams last played. If I think about it now, I think there's only four games left. Indeed, there are. They played 16 games against each other already, split evenly 8-8. Ruben Gotai to lead off against Bastano, who deals a breaking ball strike over the outside corner, nothing and one. For Pestano, this will be his 8th appearance of the year. He has struggled, no record, and a 7.71 ERA. 6 runs on 8 hits and a walk over 7 innings with 8 strikeouts. 0-1, and Gotai takes inside. Now we'll even up the count. Wander Perez goes 1 inning in the 8th, allows a hit. The 2-out double to Jordan Pacheco, no walks and struck out 1. Gotai, meanwhile, is 0-for-3. He is grounded into a double play and bounced to 2nd and 3rd as well. 1-1, swinging a line drive into left field. That's a good start for the Ducks here in the bottom of the 9th. An opposite field single for Ruben Gotai. So he is on to begin the inning. And again for the Ducks, they're not going to tie the game with one swing of the bat. They have to piece it together like Bridgeport did on Friday and Sunday when they faced big deficits. So Gotai is on to begin. 6th straight game in which he has reached base safely. That will bring up the second baseman, Elmer Reyes. First pitch on the way. Reyes takes the slider off the outside corner. Count 1-0, Reyes 1-for-3 on the night. Doubled to left and scored back in the 5th inning, sandwiched in between a pair of strikeouts. Went down looking in the 2nd and swinging in the 6th. Here's the 1-0. Fouled off at home plate, off the edge of the glove of the catcher Molina. That'll even things up at 1-1 on Perez, and you've got Berg next. Between Reyes and Lyons, 4 straight righties due up for the Ducks, one of them at the plate right now. Here's the 1-1. Reyes a swing and a miss. He cuts through the slider over the outside corner. So now the count of 1-2 as Reyes is behind against Pestano. Go tie the runner at first base with nobody out. Ducks being out hit in this game 15-7. And the 1-ball, 2-strike pitch on the way from Pestano. Reyes swings and fouls it over the screen back behind home plate. Fighting one off, and we'll do it once again. So that'll be another 1-ball, 2-strike pitch coming. Kicking the offering on the way, and Reyes a half swing. They appeal the first, and Warren Nicholson says he went around. So there is strike 3 on Reyes, third time he has struck out tonight. And 1 down for Long Island here in the bottom of the 9th inning. Could not hold up on the check swing. And for Long Island's offense, the 12th time they have struck out in this game. So one away, and the catcher Alex Berg will come to the plate from the right side. Berg 1-for-3 on the evening. The Castano set at the belt. And the first pitch, way up and outside for ball one to Berg, who hit an RBI ground rule double to center in the fifth and scored later in the inning on Quentin Berry's RBI single, but has struck out twice as well, once swinging in the third and then looking in the seventh. 1-0. And Berg takes a fastball over the inside corner for strike one. Castano made 8 appearances last year in the Yankees organization at AAA, had a 3.38 ERA, 16 strikeouts in 10 2/3 innings. Has spent time in the big leagues with the Indians and the Angels. As Berg fouls one off to the first base side, this will go back into the crowd, right into the front row behind the dugout. And the count 1-2. Castano made 223 appearances in the big leagues, had a 2.98 ERA, 6-8 record, 11 saves. He struck out 244 batters in 2 2/3 innings. Not a bad major league career for Vinny Pestano. He finds himself now in his first season in the Atlantic League. So it'll be a 1-ball, 2-strike pitch here to the catcher, Alex Berg. Kicking the offering, Berg, a line drive into left field. There's a base hit for Alex Berg. Go time will go to second and stop right there. Ducks not going down without a fight. 2 singles here in the ninth inning. The Ducks with runners at first and second, 1 out for Giovanni Alfonso.
Third base for number 6, Giovanni Alfonso, number 6.
So here is Alfonso from the right side. A very brief conversation out on the mound between Pestano and Molina. 2-1, 1 out for the Ducks. They now have 8 hits in the ballgame. For Berg, his second hit of the night. And here is Giovanni Alfonso. Alfonso and Cleary Jr., the only two Ducks who have yet to reach. And first pitch misses outside for ball one. Alfonso has grounded a short, popped to center, and struck out swinging in his 3 at-bats. And trying to keep this rally going in the bottom of the ninth. It'll be a 1-0. Here's the pitch. Alfonso swings through a fastball over the outside corner. And that'll even the count up at 1-1. And again, it's that plate discipline. When you're trying to rally late in the game, you've got to be very disciplined at the plate. And try to avoid swinging at pitches outside the zone. One one, and Alfonso chases another offering over the outside corner for strike two. So the count goes to 1-2 with 1 out. Angelo Sacco has a bat on the top step of the dugout, but no helmet yet. Not sure if he'll go in and pinch hit for anybody at any point. 1-2 delivery. Pestano fires, and Alfonso another swing and a miss at the slider off the outside corner for strike three. Second strikeout of the inning for Pestano. For the Ducks, their 13th strikeout tonight. 2 away in the last hope for Long Island will be the shortstop, Dan Lyons.
Dan Lyons, number 12.
So here is Dan Lyons to the plate from the right side. 2 on, 2 out, and the Ducks trailing 8-2. First pitch on the way from Pestano. Lyons takes a slider over the outside corner for strike one. Lyons has been on base twice tonight. He drew a walk back in the third inning and reached on an infield single in the fifth, a comebacker that hit off of the leg or the foot of Manny Parra, the starter, who is in line for the win here in his Bluefish debut. 0-1. Ground ball, weakly hit to second base. This should do it. Fielded by Abreu, he throws on a first in time for the out. This ball game is over, and the Bridgeport Bluefish have taken the opening game of this 4-game weekend series by the final count of 8-2, handing the Ducks their third consecutive defeat. So a tough way to start this very important series for the Long Island Ducks. After 3 scoreless innings, John Brownell faltered in the fourth and the fifth. The bullpen did not help matters. And the Ducks managed just 2 runs on 8 hits tonight. A as they fall for the third straight time. In the ninth, no runs, two hits, and two left for Long Island. Don't go anywhere. The postgame show is coming up next. We're going to recap this game and hand out the Player of the Game Award. Ducks fall 8-2.
Hey, fans. This is infielder Cody Puckett, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
M&V Limousines is the official bus company of the Long Island Ducks. Family owned and operated, they've been in the business for over 24 years. M&V Limousines offers coach buses with Wi-Fi and restrooms, party buses, exotic limousines, and also recently acquired Hampton Luxury Liner with regular service from New York City to the Hamptons. They also offer a variety of vineyard tour options. Whether you're looking for transportation for weddings, proms, corporate outings, or long distance trips, they've got the right vehicle for you. Visit their showroom in Comac or check them out online at mvlimo.com. M&V Limousines and Hampton Luxury Liner, the official bus company of the Long Island Ducks.
Family fun every time.
Beautiful evening for baseball.
Big action every time.
He reaches up, it's gone!
Great value every time.
And the Ducks have won it 7-1.
The Ducks schedule is loaded with new promotions this season. And with an average ticket price of just $10 and free parking, there is no better value on Long Island. For game times and tickets, visit liducks.com. Long Island Ducks Baseball. Good times every time.
Final here tonight at Bethpage Ballpark as the Bridgeport Bluefish defeat the Long Island Ducks 8-2 to take the opening game of this series. Not the way the Ducks wanted to start off, arguably their most important series of the year. But the Bluefish come away with the win. They improved to 15-12 here in the second half, and now 15 games over 500 overall, 56-41. As for Long Island, they have dropped their third straight game. For the first time, or second time, excuse me, here in the second half, they are now 11-15. Four games under 500 in the second half, and 47-49 overall this season. Neither side was able to play to run through the first three innings of the game. A good pitcher's duel in the early going between John Brownell of Long Island and Manny Parra of the Bluefish. John Brownell had gotten out of some jams, runner at second, nobody out in the second, and two on one out in the third, got out of each of those jams. But in the fourth inning, ran into some trouble. With one out in the inning, Jonathan Galvez doubled to left, and that brought up Daniel Fields, who lifted a two-run home run to straightaway center. His 11th of the year gave the Bluefish a 2-0 lead. And following an error from Gustavo Molina and back-to-back singles by Tony Abreu and then Wellington Dotel, on Dotel's single, Molina was able to score when Mark Kraus bobbled the ball in left field. And so the error brought in a run, an unearned run, that made it 3-0. And then after that, Darby Myers came to the plate and hit an RBI single to left. A total of six straight reached with one out against Brownell in the fourth. And in the inning, four runs on five hits and two errors gave the Bluefish four runs and a 4-0 lead. They added another in the fifth inning when, with two outs, Jonathan Galvez hit a deep solo home run to left center, his 11th of the season. That made it 5-0, and Brownell would get out of the inning, but that would be all for him. Meanwhile, Manny Parra was cruising through the first four innings. He allowed just two walks and no hits over the first four, striking out five, but got into trouble in the fifth inning with one out. Reyes and Berg hit back-to-back doubles. Berg's RBI ground rule double, his 25th run batted into the year, made it a 5-1 game. And then after a two-out infield single by Dan Lyons, Quentin Berry grounded an RBI single up the middle, scoring Alex Berg. That made it 5-2. And all of a sudden, the Ducks had runners at the corners, two out, and the tying run at the plate in the former Delta Cleary Jr. But like last night, where the Ducks missed out on several opportunities, they miss out on one there as Cleary Jr. strikes out swinging, chasing a breaking ball down in the dirt. That was the story of the night for the Ducks offense, who struck out 13 times in this one. And it kept it a 5-2 game, and then Bridgeport would put the game away over the next two innings. In the sixth inning, following a leadoff triple by Tony Abreu, Wellington Dotel hit his first home run of the year, a two-run blast to left off of Tyler Levine. And then in the seventh, with one out, Daniel Fields hit his second home run of the night, an opposite field solo blast left off of Patrick Kreider. Four home runs on the night for the Bridgeport Bluefish. Those two blasts made it 8-2, and Long Island was unable to get any closer. They picked up a leadoff single and a stolen base from Pacheco in the sixth, but couldn't score. A two-out double from Pacheco in the eighth, could not score. And then a pair of singles in the ninth, a leadoff hit from Gotay and a one-out hit from Berg. But Alfonso struck out, Lyons grounded out, and that's how the game ended. Bridgeport with an 8-2 win. Final totals from tonight, 8 runs, 15 hits, and an error for Bridgeport. They left 7 on base for the Ducks. 2 runs, 8 hits, and 3 errors. They, too, left 7. Manny Parr, the win in his Bluefish debut. He struck out 7 over 5 and 2/3 innings of 2-run ball. He improves to 1-0. John Brownell suffers the loss to fall to 8-3. He lasts 5 innings for the second straight start and allows 5 runs, 4 of them earned on 10 hits, striking out 2. No save. The game took 2 hours and 43 minutes in front of 4,715 here at Bethpage Ballpark. Tonight's player of the game, we're going to give it to Daniel Fields, the left fielder for Bridgeport. He and Jonathan Galvez both had 3 hits nights, but Fields with 2 homers, 3 RBIs, and 2 runs scored stood out above them all, and Fields is our player of the game here for the series opener. We'll take one more break when we come back, the out-of-town scores, and then we'll wrap things up from the Duck Pond.
Hey fans, this is shortstop Dan Lyons, and you're listening to Ducks Baseball on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network.
Long Island's Ford Giant is celebrating its 60th year anniversary. Stop by Sayville Ford to check out their state-of-the-art showroom featuring enclosed service drives, luxurious customer lounge, and a larger selection to choose from. Get giant savings on hundreds of new and used vehicles in stock. Sayville Ford's 60th anniversary celebration is going on now. Visit SaylvilleFord.com or download the Sayville Ford app today to learn more about Sayville Ford's 60th anniversary savings. Call 631-589-4800 today.
Have your birthday at the ballpark this season and celebrate with the flock. Kona Ice birthday party packages with the Long Island Ducks are now available. Each package includes 10 box seats, a commemorative birthday t-shirt and autographed baseball, a pizza and Kona Ice party in the Hebrew National picnic area, and so much more. Best of all, the birthday child will stand on the dugout while the entire crowd sings happy birthday. Reserve your party today by calling the group sales department at 631-940-3825. Kona Ice birthday parties with the Long Island Ducks, a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Back here one final time at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, or excuse me, at Bethpage Ballpark, not the home of the Bluefish. We're at the home of the Ducks, but it was the Bluefish who came up with a win tonight, 8-2, to take the opening game of this four-game series. Ducks losing their third in a row and now falling to 3.5 games back of Bridgeport in the Liberty Division standings. Let's take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. A game has just gone final in the bottom of the ninth inning at Clipper Magazine Stadium. Barnstormers defeat the Skeeters 4-3. Brad Bergeson started for Lancaster, and Jake Hale started for Sugarland. Bergeson is going to get the win, and Hale will suffer the loss. The save is going to go to Anthony Carter. Now, the Barnstormers were led offensively by Garner, Halton, Clevenger, and Millage, who each picked up a run batted in the game. Garner had 2 hits. Sugarland, meanwhile, got 2 hits and all 3 RBIs off the bat of Kevin Ahrens. Meanwhile, the York Revolution are looking like they're going to pick up a victory. They are in the bottom of the eighth inning in New Britain, and they lead it 10-4. Over the Bees. Ricardo Gomez now on a pitch for York after Logan Williamson started for the Revolution, and Jonathan Pettibone in for the New Britain Bees after Brian Dupre started the ballgame. Revolution led offensively tonight by Jared Mitchell, who is 3-for-4 with 2 RBIs and 3 runs scored. Telvin Nash has also driven in 3 runs, and meanwhile for New Britain, 2 RBIs from John Griffin to lead the way. Somerset, and Southern Maryland are both off tonight. Earlier today, the Rockies won it in walk-off fashion 5-4 over the New York Mets. Greg Holland, the win, improved to 2-1, and Hansel Robles, the loser, fell to 6-3. Charlie Blackmon, his 25th home run, and Mark Reynolds, his 23rd for Colorado, and Yoenis Cespedes hit his 11th of the season for the Mets in defeat. Meanwhile, the Yankees right now trailing the Cleveland Indians 5-1, bottom of the 8th inning in Cleveland. Sonny Gray, in his Yankees debut, allowed 4 runs, 2 earned, on 4 hits and 3 walks over 6 innings, striking out 6. He is in line for the loss. Corey Kluber, meanwhile, has thrown 8 innings of 1-run ball, striking out 10. And he's allowed just 3 hits and a walk. One of the 3 hits, Gary Sanchez with his 17th home run of the season. Meanwhile, Francisco Lindor has gone deep for Cleveland, his 18th of the year. Hall of Fame game in Canton, Ohio. The Arizona Cardinals lead the Dallas Cowboys 15-10, just about at halftime there. And at 10 o'clock Eastern, the United States women's national team will take on Japan out in Carson, California, in the Tournament of Nations. So that does it for the out-of-town scoreboard. Tomorrow, the Ducks and the Bluefish will play game 2 of this series. Henderson Alvarez will go for Long Island, 0-1 thus far, but has a 0.90 ERA and pitched pretty well last Sunday up in Bridgeport. Through 4 scoreless innings, allowed 3 hits and 3 walks, striking out 5 and threw 72 pitches, 39 of them for strikes. Got a no decision in the game that the Ducks ended up losing. but he is scheduled to go tomorrow for Long Island. And meanwhile, he'll oppose the man he did last Sunday, and that is right-hander Rainey Lara, the lone Bluefish pitcher still left over from their opening rotation of the season. He pitched in that game and was roughed up, gave up 11 hits and 7 runs over 5 innings, walked 4 batters, and struck out 4. Again, that was the game in which the Ducks built an early 7-0 lead, took it into the 8th, but ultimately lost that one by the final count of 8-7, and that is why both pitchers took no decisions. More Alvarez, the fact that he only went 4 innings, but ultimately would have gotten into no decision anyway if he had gone 5. So a matchup of right-handers on the mound tomorrow. The Ducks will look to even up this 4-game series at 1 apiece. That'll do it for us tonight here at Bethpage Ballpark. Again, the final score was the Bluefish 8 and the Ducks 2. We invite you to join us for our next Ducks broadcast, which will be tomorrow night when these two teams hook up for the second of 4 games in this series. Pre-game show is going to begin at 6:20, the first pitch at 6:35, and you can follow all the action right here on the Long Island Ducks Broadcast Network. My name is Michael Pollack. Thank you so very much for spending your Thursday night with me. I hope you enjoyed the broadcast. Have a great rest of your Thursday night. We'll do it all over again on Friday evening here on Long Island. Good night and so long from the Duck Pond.